What's up, friends of the good mood? This is Money, and welcome to the 3.8 update and the dance floor. We can see here, this really looks like a crazy dance floor right now, guys. We have a new update that came out with a lot of new stuff. You can see here, hold on, there it is. You can see the new Flux weapon. I already have it for the Fury, so I can show you guys right off the bat how it looks like at Mark II level 12. You can see right here on the Fury times 3, we have the Raven. I just thought, hey, a double jump Griffin, a Raven, why not put some Vortex and Aphid on it, as you can see right here. Then we have a viewer request later as a golem with Flux, Gecko, and medium trebuchet, which is called Ballista, which is also new, and you can see it here. I put it on Bulgazari, right? Let's see how all those things are, and this is not the only things that are new. In case you want to buy yourself a Doc or something, right? The Doc and the Butch and Jesse, they no longer cost, oh god, we already have a donation? What the heck? We just started. They no longer cost, these Facebook points, influence points. They now cost gold, and the Doc is a really good offer for 1,250 gold here, guys. And something I would probably consider doing if I didn't have already a Doc on my own account. What was that? Hey, Money, let's start with the stream. Thanks for all you've been doing. War Robots for you. Yo, I'm Yellow Snow again. $25 right away. Man, thank you, my friend. Much appreciated. All right, you know what, guys? That's an early one. Let's jump into the next thing that is new. The free-for-all game mode, guys. Everyone versus everyone. Six players just whooping the heck out of each other. This is so much fun. Oh my god, I can't believe, of course the Fury isn't exactly the one thing you want to run on it, but it's certainly an interesting and fun setup to use. Okay, I already see a Griffin, kind of. He's being attacked by something to the side. Maybe I can steal the kill. Yep, I did get the kill stolen. Haha, that was my kill. See, and that's, ladies and gentlemen, that's free for all for you. You're just stealing kills from enemies, and you don't have to actually do the damage yourself. It's kind of enough if you just get the kill. I wonder if he's gonna get the full kill. Maybe this guy's just gonna hop around the corner. Oh, come on. No, he did get the kill. Dang it. I was trying to be the one killing him right there, but that was not possible for me at this point. But I can do it right now, hopefully. He got around the corner. He got some backup. Every time I jump, the enemy somehow gets into cover. So I'm trying to fake to go to this side, and then go abruptly to the other side. I really need to get him killed super quick. I just can't get him. He constantly moves away from me. In 7 seconds, I have my jump, but that will probably be too late. And he will already have been killed by somebody else, I suppose. Is he? Oh, come on. Oh, you know what? Oh, this is just ludicrous right now. Will I ever gonna get him? Oh boy, that was so close. I think somebody else was just about to hit him and get the last kill. Oh wow, dude. Oh, come on. You really spawn right here? Oh man, that's some super terrible bad luck on my part. He was allowed to spawn right next to me after I used my jump ability, and my weapons are empty. Oh man, okay. But you know, this is the new map called Carrier, and we have the new game mode Free for All in action. He's hitting me quite well right there. Oh, I wanted to corner shoot him, but you know what, forget it. He's just waiting for me to do my move right there. Yeah, he's just gonna wiggle me down. He's slowly but surely wiggle me down until I have no health left. I have... Oh my god. Really? Did that just really happen to me? Oh boy. And there he walks away, and there he gets me. Bam. GG. GG. I couldn't have walked into that trap any more devastatingly than I just did. I just absolutely killed myself. I messed up the jump, and that was the one thing that I should not have been doing. I shouldn't have messed that jump up. But that was rightfully my kill. Chip, mine, just stolen. And the next guy, just stolen completely. Oh man, free for all. I guess this is gonna be a game mode that will, get you really heated up. Like, people constantly stealing your kills, that will for sure gonna make you, like, really, really angry about this game. Oh no, oh no. Oh no! No, I just fell from the bridge. I totally underestimated how freaking far this thing jumps. It jumps so ridiculously far. Oh my goodness. Did you see that? I think I crossed like the entire freaking ship in this one jump. Oh boy. So I hope he... Oh my... You, the amount of dashes this Kamiho has, it's just never ending. The amount of dashes this thing has, it's just absolutely insane. It's just non-stop dashing. It looks like it will continuously forever dash. Whew, thankfully I got the kill though. Oh man, I just totally jumped into the water. You know what? The good thing is, finally we know what happens when you jump into the water, right? Oh yeah, he kind of made a whoop that target. Now he's gonna whoop me too. Actually, you know what? We have a chance. Yup, I got him. Wow, that was close. Oh, we have a Lancelot coming from behind. Oh no. Oh no. there's way too much action going on in this game mode, dude. It's just insane. Oh boy, I'm so excited about all this. The new things, new weapons. We're gonna have a look at all these things. What is this? What's up with this dude? He's standing up there with his... Maybe I can jump into his shield. That would be super awesome. Let's see if that works. Okay, I'm here, bud. Yeah! I was able to do it! Yeah, protect me, shield! No, where's my shield? How dare you, shield? Shield just went away. I'm just gonna try to bring down his shield there. But damn it. Oh, man. Okay, there we go with the second last bot we have. And, oh, I guess I can make him jump. He's gonna jump now, but... See, I knew that was gonna happen. But now he has no longer has a jump. I'm locking on to him right there. So that once this guy drops his ability... Like this... Oh, no. Aww! That was way too fast! Why did you not walk down the ramp? I don't understand why this guy did not walk down the ramp. He should've. Oh boy, now he's getting attacked now. So one jump, second jump, one, two, three, four, Leroy! Oh god, look where I am! Oh man, this is it, that's death for me right now. This is, it's no free-for-all bot, guys. This is not a free-for-all bot. You shouldn't be running a Griffin with, or any bot with Vortex and Aphid if you're playing free-for-all, because as a matter of fact, you're just gonna get killed. And you have very little you can do against the enemy. Ah, my kill! Oh boy, I just took that one. Actually, I think I worked him down anyways, so... Let's regenerate some of our flux right here. I'm not sure if he's reloading too. No, he doesn't seem to be. He must be reloading at some point though. I think now he might be reloading. Yep, you can see he's not shooting, so we can bring him down. And there goes the full Lancelot, ladies and gentlemen. Oh boy. You know, this once again is not a bot you should be running in free for all. If you want to play free for all, what you do, you lock in your brawlers. You lock in your brawling bots, because look what's happening now. An Haichi is coming towards me with three medium Tyrants, just waiting for me to whoop me like instantly. The second he comes out, he's gonna dash at me and just one hit kill me pretty much. And there is little to nothing I can do about it. Yeah. The problem of course is also that we have a corner shooting Haichi, my weapons are broken on the wrong side. But let's see, we can restore a bot. Using these points that we have. Let's restore this one because this is the guy we just jumped into the lake, into the ocean. So, I guess this guy is going to be... I have 800 meters to go. He will get killed by... Yeah, there it is. That was a very low chance for me to actually get that kill before somebody else gets it. It's a Griffin. Huh. So, with an RDB is that... I wonder if they may have fixed the plasma bug. We're gonna have to see if they fixed the plasma bug because I haven't seen the plasma bug in a while. So, quick direction changes all the time and I get to... Oh man, dude, they all are in range. Like seriously, everyone is in range. I don't want to restore another bot, and I think I don't have to. If we just wait it out for a second, we're gonna have one anyways with the most kills. Or do I have to have a bot still left on the field? I guess we're gonna see. Yep, first place. So you don't have to have a bot on the field. It's okay if you have the most kills. You don't have to spend your points. So yeah, we have already seen quite a bit, and we've already, you know, seen what happens when you jump off the carrier, which of course I did totally on purpose, right? I just wanted to show you what happens when you jump down there. It was no accident, not at all. So yeah, let's go for another run and free for all, ladies and gents. That's so cool. I love this game mode, man. I'm so hyped that it is in the live game mode, in the live servers now, guys. And by the way, like I said, I wanted to see if the plasma bug still exists, because so far I think I haven't seen it yet. Now that doesn't have to necessarily mean much, but there is a chance that they may have fixed that, right? So I guess we're going with the plasma Spectre first. Oh boy, I don't know what they have here. There's a Spectre with Shock Train right next to me, and I guess he's gonna have a bit of a problem right now. So there we go. 1, 2, and 3. There he goes. Wow, and this guy just wanted to steal it. Oh, we have one coming in from KH Vathiel. I need to read that later, but for now, just see what we can do here. I know there's a Bulgazari Scourge behind this corner, and he's just waiting for his chance right there. Problem is, with Plasma, I can do very little against the Scourge, against the Scourged Bulgazari, because he can kind of shoot me while his shield is pointed my way. I think he's coming now to me. That's awesome. Now if he's coming to me, then I have a chance, because then I can just use my stealth ability, my stealth jump at the exact right time. So here we go. I'm shooting onto him from above, where his shield doesn't really help him. There we go. Nice. Okay. Thanks for that kill, Bulgazari Shock Scourge. You shouldn't have given that to me. I think this guy has rockets on him. That looks like somebody with, oh yeah, here he comes. Walking sideways to the right makes it so that I don't get hit as much with this, with these weapons. So something is shooting us into the flank. And I don't think I'm gonna get him. Nope, the other dude got him. Damn it. Now that was really bad luck there on my part. I should have not jumped out so soon. You know, let's reload the Tyrants just to be sure, because the Griffin has still like 10 seconds left on the jump ability, and we have the Bulgazari Shock Train coming up. I'm hoping he will shoot him. Will he? He's not shooting anybody. He could look. He has line of sight. He could shoot him. He doesn't want to, because now he fired. Okay. He didn't want to shoot him because he wanted to get the kill. And you don't get the kill if you use your firepower to deal damage to the enemy, right? So he's gonna shoot me in 2, 1. Okay, now he sees that shield popping into his side. So he may not be actually shooting. So I'm waiting for my chance here. And got this kill. And yeah, let me reload so I can get the last kill here too. There we go. Nice. Triple kill. Haha! Woo! That's right. Uh-oh. We have the Lancelot coming up. I'm breaking through his physical shield without showing myself right now. Alright. I'm reloading now. Look, he wants me. Uh-oh. Oh, no! Where did this guy come from? Oh, my goodness. I already planned the next move. I already knew what was gonna happen. I already knew how I was gonna get my next kill. And then this guy came around and just absolutely destroyed me right there. So, I'm making this Bulgazari shoot him. So, now he's gonna open fire. No, he's not. You know what? I'm gonna pick you, then. First you, and then you. It's all about spreading the damage in a very useful way, right? I could have killed the Lancelot first, but this way I would have only gotten one of them, and I would have probably also gotten some damage. The way I did it now, I didn't take any damage, and I got both kills. So this guy's walking away from me. Oh, we have another Bolgazari shock train standing up on that ledge. I'm acting like I didn't know that he's there. Okay, he dashed once. He will have a second dash. Here he comes. Where's the second dash? Where's your second dash, dude? Oh, well. Oh, man. And there goes a Bolgazari shock train. By the way, having one ECU shield or echo shield or whatever on the Spectre is, in my opinion, the best thing you can do. Three weapons is still way too powerful for this game, and having this extra special ECU shield allowing you to just protect yourself from certain things, that's gonna be a bit of a problem. Come on, stay with me, dude. Come on! Where you going? Where are you going? Oh my goodness, he is just running away forever. Alright, there we go, kill. And let's do the same thing again to him. Here comes the Spectre train, that's right. Hold on, I'm almost there. Almost there. There we go, boom. This is really funny, guys. This is just too good. Of course I'm breaking my shield by doing this. I could have probably also destroyed the shield, but you know what? It's just fun. It's just fun as heck to do this. So, whatever this is up there, somebody's firing with plasma. That might be another Ancelot. I'm not going to survive another attempt to go up to these guys. So, you have to jump now. Yeah, and he does. See that? So, he's going to try to hit me now. Ah! Well, he went into this he basically went and killed himself. How far is he, the other guy? No, there is no other guy. Though, there is another guy, though. There he is. He is just coming from behind, it seems. What I really hate, you probably know what I mean, is that when you land after a jump and your legs are turned sideways and you have this weird thing where you walk super slow and sideways instead of just going forward. You know what? I want this little column here in front of me. This little pillar actually protects me very well. As you can see here. And if I make it smart, I might be able to just fire at him right there. So here we go. Now let's go and kill him real quick. Boom. Nice. Another Bolgazari bites the dust. You see, guys, this physical shield on the Spectre is way more powerful than just having a separate weapon. It just makes such a big difference to have this additional weapon, guys. So there's an Inquisitor. If I could make him jump first, we still have 2 minutes 40 seconds left on the clock. If I could make this guy jump first, that would be a major success. And there it is. He's now jumping. So all I have to do is just pick him first. There we go. Nice. And now I have to get rid of this guy. Ooh, his shield is still up. Oh no, this is gonna be crazy. His shield is still up. I only need to get a few more hits in. Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Ah, yes! Woo! We made it. I didn't think that we was gonna be able to make it, but we did. That was like a double. It couldn't have gone any closer than this. One jump. Alright, he spawned in something else. He scouted what I used. Did you see that? He basically scouted what I have, and so he dropped something with an energy shield because I run the Vortex and Aphid. But I have to read the donations coming in. I will do this, guys. Just give me a second, okay? So, here we go. Alrighty, so far so good. We have 2 jumps to use on this thing. So far we have only used one of them. Alrighty, relocking on. I'm not sure if I can handle this this guy, but I'm going to try. And now I made him jump down. See that? That was perfect. Now he's sitting down there, and he can't get back up without walking all the way over around the side. That was like a super cool thing. Why did he not take any damage right there? Dude, you should have suffered major damage. I just can't kill him. Dude, it's just... this weapon is just not capable. Now, finally, he's reloading. Hopefully, I get my chance right here. Nope. He gets this 1 HP still. And he is in cover. There was like a 90% chance to drop on the ground and have him in line of sight. But it didn't work. Yeah, he's not gonna give me that additional kill. Why would he? But see, that's why you should never, if you're attempting to play Free For All, guys, never put Vortex, Aphid, Thermite in your hangar. Forget it. It's absolutely worthless. The only place where it works is if you have beacon bases and people are using cover and not, you know, coming from all sides, but you have like a line going through the teams and you can use cover and just fire over obstacles the whole time. You can't do it here really on Free For All because people are coming from every angle and you just end up with a weapon that is absolutely ineffective against pretty much everything. Physical shield, nothing. Energy shield, nothing. You have no effective weapon against anything. So try not to go with this weapon if you are playing Free For All. We had Boob, have you jumped off the edge of a barge by accident yet? Well, that by accident? No, I did it on purpose, of course. And then we have here Gorewalk Scythe donated 40 Indian rupees to Super Chat. Got to see you kills are reduced if you destroy your bot. Yeah, in Free For All, if you destroy your own bot, you will have your kills taken away from you, so that you're no longer in lead, or, you know, that you have a punishment for just sacrificing your bot like this. I think we're also going to play a different game mode in a few seconds, guys, but let me just say 1,400 something plus viewers right now. Holy crap. This is insane. I have to actually update this. Hold on. There it is. So now, it should be displayed correctly. I don't think I will be able to steal... oh, maybe I will steal that kill. Nope. I should have jumped a little bit. All my rockets went somewhere where they shouldn't have gone. Did you see what just happened? Why? Because I was so high over the enemy, my rockets went all into the ground. And now I haven't done the damage that I was supposed to do here. And as a result, he may actually kill me. No, I got him, but... that is something you need to keep in mind. If you jump at somebody with a Spectre, the angle of your rockets coming in is so weird. The angle of your firepower. See, no plasma bug yet. So he doesn't want to fight me yet because I had the stealth ability, but now he's gonna come. But since I have the physical shield, even with a double dash, but he's gonna get killed in a few seconds. I think. I'm going to interfere and attack this guy here directly. And I actually got it. Wait a minute, did he kill the Bulgazari? Yes, he did. He must have. I'm literally surrounded by enemies from all angles. No matter where I go, I'm gonna get killed. Ooh, do. From behind, from the front, everyone comes. Everyone targets me because I'm the quick one-hit kill, right? When you are the quick one-hit kill, everyone wants you because, you know, they get a point for pretty much doing nothing. So, this guy needs to jump. Maybe I can make him jump right here? Yup, I was able to. And now I'm going to jump. I will land a few seconds after him, so I will be able to probably, hopefully... you know, do you see how the weapon just completely goes right through him? The ember doesn't hit the guy. And now he's allowed to regenerate his firepower, which is something I really didn't want him to do. I think from behind, there was firepower coming in from behind right here, was it? No? Yo, this is just stupid now. He's gonna go back behind cover again, and I just can't kill him. Okay, he didn't get behind cover this time, but I should have gotten him a long time ago, but the cover always prevented me from getting to him there. Superhead just donated 25 bucks. Oh, wait, hold on, I don't have a physical shield. Wait. Oh no, what? Oh, come on, guys, where do you all come from all of a sudden? He said, greetings from the United States. They should rename Free For All to Steal the Kill Mode. Love your videos and streams. Thank you, Superhead408. Much appreciated, dude. Awesome. There it is. Now it comes in. I saw it before it came in. You know what? Even though I know it's a mistake, we're gonna still try to go with this setup. Look, I can't do anything. It's just not worth it. I can try to bring down the shield and it will not matter. I will never get this guy killed. Not with this weapon. It's an absolute worthless weapon configuration to run on Free For All. I need to change the hangar. I wanted to show you the Raven, but unfortunately, like, this setup here does not work. Oh, I can't believe we actually killed him there. I thought we were never gonna do this, guys. All right, let's do one jump and a second jump and boom from high up. Boom! Yes! That was cool. That was a good hit. Maybe we can sneak the kill. Hold on. Do some more damage. Come on, Kamiho. Do a little bit more damage to him. A little bit more. Alright, let's see. Yes! Snucked it! That's mine! Oh, man. This is just too good. Just stealing the kills left and right. Oh no. What is this? Dragoon, go away. Ah, I hate your dragoon. Yeah, here, Norifit. Stupendous called these rockets Norifit. He meant the Aphid, but they came in like a Noricum because they went in from such a high angle, and so he's called them Norifit, and I just pooped my pants for laughing, man. That was just too good. Norifit. It happens on certain locations on the map. No, you're not going to get me. I get killed by somebody else from behind. What? You just fired into the— how did you get me? It, on my screen, you fired into the wall, dude. Oh, wow, he's getting some. Yeah! Such a tiny little angle. Just so small, and I still got him somehow. Oh, boy. So, you're gonna jump now, I know, because you don't want to take so much damage for no reason. And I need to get myself in safety from this jump. Like this. Regenerate my... What are you getting? You're getting stuck there, huh? Oh, am I gonna get killed? Yeah! Oh, cool! You know, these flux guys, the flux level 12 Mark II, it actually goes quite well. I must say, it does quite some damage. I think this guy will jump at me in 3, 2, 1. Haha, see? I almost knew exactly when he was gonna try it. So, I'm trying to get him before he really gets the full line of sight with me. Come on. Yes! 3 kills just gotten with the Fury and having 2, 3 of these weapons on it. That was cool. So, am I gonna be able to sneak another one in? Just kill that. I just wanna kill steal. I don't wanna deal the damage, I need to just kill steal. That's all I do. That's what I do. It's my hobby. It's just kill stealing everything. So I'm trying to I'm acting like I don't know where he is. I'm acting like I'm busy with something. Look, I'm shooting into the other direction. Now he thinks, this is my chance. And then he comes and gets whooped. Yeah! It worked perfectly, dude. I didn't even have anyone to shoot at, but because of the fact that I turned around and fired in some general direction, he was like, oh yes, he forgot about me. And of course, he comes, gets killed. Too good, man. Alright, so I think I could, you know, I could spend these points now to drop in with another bot. You know what? Actually, I'm going to do this because I just saw that multiple people are dropping in. This guy also came with something. Alright, here we go. Of course, I'm lucky he has some random cover just completely blocking this 1 meter that I'm about to hit him there. Okay, got him. Poof. But look how much damage he still did to me. That was insane. I only have one Tauron left, really? Oh boy. Okay, let's restore another one. Oh, and I'm dropping in on the complete opposite side. Damn it. Am I all the way down in the chat? I think my chat isn't even all the way down. This old frickin' wooden PC that I'm using to display the stream chat, man. It's so old. So here, see the angle of which the rockets come in. It's just weird. It's just really weird. When you jump up, they just sometimes they go right straight down and you don't hit the enemy. Is the update life? Yes, the random king. The update is life. Plasma buck spotted? No, I think I was missing him. I don't think that was the plasma buck yet. Ah, I'm making him waste his firepower there. And now I'm pretty much just taking down his shield. See, now he already lost his shielding there. He's taking additional damage. He knows what will happen if he just engages me in a one-on-one. I will simply just... Maybe I can kill him without using my stealth ability. Let's see, that would be cool. Without using the stealth ability. He's probably like, why is he not using his stealth ability? Well, because I don't need it. I get you without stealth. I don't need no stealth. Yes! even though he has dash and energy shield and more base HP, I was still able to kill him there because he played differently. He expected me to do the stealth jump. And because of the fact that he expected me to do the stealth jump, that was kind of the reason why he played in a different way. Whoa. Okay. 13 seconds, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bye-bye! Yes! Perfectly. It went perfect till the end. Oh, man. Too good. Of course, I have to say at this point, guys, this time we're running a really powerful hangar, right? I'm running a very powerful hangar with two times my favorite bots right now. I mean, the Spectre is like everyone's favorite bot right now, of course. It's just so powerful. But what makes it favorite for me is the fact that it has a shield. And with this shield, you can make so much cool stuff with it. You can do so many crazy and funny things with this. And that's why I kind of love this here, having the shield up on it and all that. So, yeah. Really, really cool. And my most favorite setup is with storms. Three storms and the ECU shield. You're gonna get a video about this in, coming up really soon. Let's change the weapons here on the Griffin, because it doesn't make any sense to run this right now. Let's go with Pinata. No, damn, I don't have any further Orkins, I think. Let's go with Scourge and Gecko or something, right? Something crazy, I don't know. So that we still have... Look, why does a Mark 1 weapon come first in the list compared to Mark 2 weapons? What the heck? What kind of sword system is that? Oh, you want to use the weak weapons first, right? Oh, here they are. Doesn't make any sense. Oh, well. So, Gecko and Scourge. Money, show us the Workshop 2.0. This is the first time I'm opening this. It's not the 2.0 workshop. It's still the old one, as you can see here. The 2.0 workshop is not yet in the game, it seems. Maybe they're gonna activate this a little bit later, but right now this is still the old one. The new one will look different. You will be able to craft components for your whatever you want to see. So who said it? Fred Hain. I can't show it to you yet. Oh, hey, wrong game mode. Let's go with Free For All a little bit more. Discord link, please. Abelona is asking the Discord link. Yes. Hold on. Invite people. Copy. There it is. And here comes the Discord group chat link, ladies and gents. So Free For All once again. Starting off this time in the Inquisitor. Let's see what we have right here. Uh-oh, we have a Haichi. Okay, there goes the Haichi HP, and... Yep, okay, that was quite an easy kill. I came in from behind, uh-oh. But you know what? You know who's an easy kill now? It's me, I'm the easy kill. Was he just firing at somebody else for a second? It looked like it. So now he's reloading, that gives me a chance. I have a fighting chance now. Because he's reloading. So, come on. Ember, reload. No! What? Who? How? Who did it? What the heck? Aladdin. Oh, man. Why don't you just go and rub your freaking lamp? Just leave my kills alone, dude. You already have a genie and all the power there is in this world. You don't need to be taking my kills. Ah. Alright, let's go with a raven here. Haha, direction change. Did not expect that, huh? Yup. He totally didn't see that one coming. Because you can now change your direction in mid-air, basically. When you use this this bot now. And the cooldown is not now quite fair too. Hold on. Oh yeah. Oh, I'm getting him. Yep, come on. Yeah! Woo! The Raven kicks some serious butt right now. And we had JD Johan with one, I think a Canadian dollar it is, saying nothing, just donating one. Thank you, man. Much appreciated. Ow. Okay, I lost. Oh, man. Okay, the tortoise got me. Where am I? Every time you spawn, you have to check where you are. Like, you don't know where you are, what's going on. Hi, Haichi. Haichi is coming for me, it seems. Yeah, he's gonna walk behind cover there. No way, man. I'm not going to attack. Nope. I'm not going to attack. There's no point for me in attacking him right now, because he will just walk behind cover. I can try to kill Steel, though, because he's getting attacked from behind, and I did get the kill. Nice. All right, so that's good. You see that? There's a little Garrett. Oh, wow. Though, let me correct myself. There was a little Garrett. What is that? A Komiho? Let's try to make him dash. Uh-oh. From behind. Oh, well, everyone wants me now, it seems. Yep. Everyone is focusing me. I'm just trying to sneak a kill here. And then maybe do some additional damage here, but unfortunately, too much going at one place. The tortoise is back. He's going to use his stealth jump in a second. If he can, that is. Nope. Apparently, he did not have a stealth jump ready anymore. He already used it. And I purposely didn't use it myself because I knew if I did, I won't have it ready again. Alright. Plasma bucks doesn't seem to be a thing right now. I'm not encountering any plasma buck at this very moment. Oh, we have a Bulgazari coming up with Orkans. We have this guy with his... plasma stuff. Oh, and I have my physical shield already broken down. That's a thing. Okay, so the only thing that can protect myself right now is my stealth jump. That's the only thing I've got. Uh-oh. Dead. Wow, they are so fast. I was so paranoid, and yet he got me from... How do you get a paranoid person from behind? I don't know, he did it. He had absolutely no problem getting me from behind, even though I was so freaking paranoid right there. Unfortunately, I didn't get this kill. And I don't think I'll be getting any further kills anymore. He's blocking everything with his shield. Nah, god damn it. See, once again, this is a fun setup, but it's not work. It doesn't work on this game mode here. Ugh. I'm just trying to break, to bypass his shield, but absolutely worthless. Let's go with the Orkan version again. Seanzilla is donating $2 saying, I base my personal hangar on your video. Thanks. Cool. Well, in this case, then enjoy, because I think it's a lot of fun. Usually I design my hangars for fun factor. I'm not usually going for what's most powerful in the game. Oh, this is good. This is gonna be good. Look, he doesn't even have an energy shield on this bot. I can just absolutely destroy him right there. Completely chanceless. This is crazy. Wow, that was really unfair, man. And he's coming again with another bot, the same bot again. What the heck? He's got the same bot again. Okay, here we go, and doing the same thing to him that we just did a few seconds ago. Another kill. Oh man, this guy must be so angry. He just encountered the same bot twice and he couldn't do a thing. And by the way, if I didn't have this physical shield, I wouldn't have been able to walk so close up to him, you know what I mean? The only reason I could do that so easily was because I could easily just walk up to this guy, shock train. What? Why? Yeah, dash into the other guy and just get yourself killed by him. Sure. These Kamihos, they're so dangerous, because usually... Oh no, my physical shield is away. Oh, thank God. He just fired into the wall. My physical shield was gone. That's crazy. So now he got me locked up. Because my physical shield is gone. Did you see what just happened? I jump stealth up, he kills me. He had no line of sight with me. I jump stealth, he kills me in stealth jump because he obviously was able to get me in sight. Okay. Whatever you say, dude. Whatever you say. So there goes this guy. All right. And there goes this guy too. Well, that was easy. Let's see where the other people are. How long you been playing the game and streaming for? Right now we're streaming for about 45 minutes and we're going for another 2 hours, maybe 2.5, depends. 1.5 or 2.5 or something. That's what we're going for. I don't know where the second person is. Yo, he got me perfectly. You see that freaking insane hit that he just gave me up there? And I missed my shot, damn it. That's it. I'm no longer gonna be able to do anything. Look, I have to reload now. No chance. They were just closing in on me so much, man. Phew. Absolute insanity. I should have reloaded my Tyrants before. I didn't do it, and I should have done it. See, the Spectre with Shock Train is still the end boss. He is still the end boss, no matter what. Alright. So, the Shock Train guy killed even some other person again. He even managed to kill yet another guy, because it's just the most powerful machine in this game right now. And he's going backwards and backwards. He's literally face-hugging the wall. He's literally hugging the wall right now. He wanted to get the stealth jump active, but I didn't give it to him. Alright, he's still... Oh man, he's so fast on his feet. Oh my god, is that thing fast? Ridiculous. Alright, there we go. Oh, there's a stealth jumping Spectre coming again. And he already did his jump. So what he's got? Another Shock Train. He's got more Shock Train on this thing. Wow, you gotta be joking me, man. Really, you're running Shock Train twice? So let's wait for him to jump. What? Oh my goodness, I totally didn't check that you could do that. I totally didn't think about this. There's, you know, it's just this. It's all he does. He just clicks the left mouse button one single tap, and that's and you die, because you take so much damage in one hit. The Taurons have to stay focused for a longer time, and that's why it doesn't work. But you know what? We still had a great match with more than 2 million damage. And it's interesting, the enemies are using a lot of Spectres now, and this guy actually had 2 Shock Train Spectres. I mean, seriously, guys. I'm not even running one of them, because they're just so ridiculously overpowered. But hey, whatever. I don't have enough space on my phone to get the update Matthias Stosiek says. Oh, sorry to hear that, man. You gotta get rid of some stuff. Yo, so I guess we're just gonna jump in again. Let's do the random mode this time, because maybe this way we can use our Flux Fury a little bit more. Let's go and do this, guys. Ooh, need something to drink. Alrighty, here we are, ladies and gents, back on, oh, King of the Hill on this map, really? I didn't even think that was possible to play King of the Hill on this map. Alright, let's go with the Griffin first, the double jump Griffin. Let's see how far we can get from up here. Boo! Yeah! That's some jump right there, man. Dude, that's insane. I'm not sure if we're gonna be able to make it, but look, we are actually as far or as fast as the hover seems to be. Even the hover doesn't seem to be particularly much faster than we are. I'm trying to get this this beacon right there in control, but I need to regenerate my things. Okay, there he goes. Does he not know I'm here? Why does this guy never see me? Oh, jump! And jump again! Woo! Oh god, no chance, man. Look, did you see that 4 versus 2 in the middle? Like, what's the rest of my team doing? Why is there a Vortex Bulgazari standing here on our... I know why they're here. They're already waiting for the next beacon. They didn't even care to help us. They were like, you know what? I don't have to go forward. I don't have to protect this beacon and try to get, you know, get our team some help. I'm just gonna sit right here. That's some team play right there. Alright, we got this beacon here. And this is right the next one. I'm gonna be the first one this time. I wanna be the one capturing the beacon, man. I will never be the one capturing a beacon, it seems. It's just impossible for me. Columbus on a... Uh-oh. We have a Shock Train Bulgazari coming up. And he did hit me. He actually managed to hit me perfectly, no problem right there. Man. I thought I was gonna be safe here behind the corner. But not, you're never safe against Shock Train. Oh, man. So the enemy is running 7 Shock Trains right now. Right? Just so you guys know, they're running 7 Shock Trains. 4 on the Spectre and 3 on the Bulgazari. And I just realized I have 0 cover if I walk further this way. Absolutely no cover. Without using the stealth jump, I'm absolutely dead against those Shock Trains. I think I should be waiting a second for my stealth jump to come back up. Maybe I can make some use out of my bot then. They are... Nah, they're not... Oh, am I seeing this right? They now have 10 Shock Trains. 6 on 2 Bulgazaris, and then they have a Spectre with 4. Okay. Speaking about many Shock Trains, huh? Oh, come on. Come on! Oh, man. I fall down here, and that's it for me, man. Oh, God. See, 4 Shock Trains aiming down on me now, and everyone... That was like 10 centimeters we're missing to get the to get up to on that ramp. And I couldn't I didn't jump far enough, and I didn't make it. Damn it. Alright, so there's a lot of Shock Trains. See how they chain over? Shock, left, right, left, right. Everyone is running Haichi, so every Shock Train is gonna fully hit everybody right there. There goes the first guy, dead. But we're winning this on beacon control. It seems like on carrier, here's something that I learned right now in this match. On carrier, the beacon rush, the game mode King of the Hill, it doesn't really work very well because you have like this line where you spawn at the back of the base, and every time you cannot get, it's impossible to get a beacon that's in the enemy base. It's impossible. So it will, I guess it will depend, the team wins which beacon, which has the first beacon spawning on their side after the middle spawn. Interesting. This is a great stream so far. Money is having fun. Yes, DL Carburetor. Yes, I'm absolutely having fun. Oh, you know what? And we can finally make some use of this thing. Right? Oh, come on. Target the right dude. All right. I want to deal some damage from here. And I want to use this weapon that I, you know, that you can't use otherwise. It's just... I actually got hit. So let's laser back, see? Yo, my geckos are a little bit stronger than yours. By the way, they're also bigger. Look at these oversized things. What the heck? Oh my god, these things are so oversized. They're way too large for this game. They should have made them smaller. Like really, like 30% smaller. They're way too large. Oh, you're really... Yeah, now he's corner shooting me with one gecko. Wow, dude. Okay. Oh, there was something coming in. Relic07, what, money, what job do you have? Except YouTube. Hold on, wait, what? Something's exploding here. YouTube is my only occupation right now. I'm focusing a lot on it. If I had something else covering like half the day every time, I wouldn't be able to give you as many videos and live streams like I do right now. So this only works because of the fact that I do have this. I focus mainly on YouTube right now. And to be honest, it's living a dream. I have been wanting to do this for so long, and yeah, it's finally working, right? It's so great. It's just a dream come true, kind of. This guy's always in cover. I just can't ever get to him. Since this is Team Deathmatch, guys, I don't have to actually walk forward and expose myself. And yeah, of course, I know this is not going to be so much fun to watch this one round here. Believe me, we're going back into free-for-all with more action after this one right now. But I want to test the Flux a little bit and make some gameplay, right? With maxed version of the Flux. I don't know what this is, like in Haichi or something right there. Taking some good hits. There we go. Haichi is exposed. Haichi's getting lasered. Grilled right there. Oh man, look, I just like killed half the Haichi at this distance. For a weapon with this much range, that's actually pretty good. We are of course losing right now. Pretty hard. Oh, he's trying to get in range. Yeah, he's trying to get into his Zeus range with 600 meters. And I'm just kind of walking away out of his range. Not allowing him to get to us. Yeah. I'm not getting any kills, or very, very few, but I am able to snipe into all different spots from pretty much everywhere right now. There we go. Yep, kill. Nice. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, I have to walk away, dudes. They're coming for me now. Look. They're coming for me. And there are a lot of them are coming for me. It's not just one guy. It's like a freaking army of darkness coming for me, man. Oh, man. And the problem is we have zero people here that could now help and defend me here in this spot. I would really need, like, somebody with crazy strong weapons like Orkans and stuff like that. Instead, I do have somebody with Orkans, but it's an enemy. He actually came all that distance just to get me killed. Look how- oh my god, everyone is coming for me, man. No chance. But hey, I can spawn here with this bad boy now. Yeah, now the guy spawns in. Sure, now you spawn in. Yeah, thanks. I could have used this guy a few seconds ago, but now he spawns in. Alright, whatever. This guy's just trying to escape somehow. We were even able to break through the physical shield of that Lancelot relatively quickly. Did you see that, guys? That was cool. Uh-oh, there's something with 500 meters rocket range, and I only have 300 meters. Look how long it takes me to get up to him. So there he goes, kill. He's probably gonna stealth jump at me. Yeah, there it is. Oh, yes, he messed it up. Yeah, he messed up the stealth jump. Woo! Thank God. Same as I did before he messed it up this time. Oh, that was so good. That was so lucky. He would have probably killed me if he hadn't messed it up. There we go. Is this guy coming? No, he's not. Oh, wow. There's a lot of dudes jumping around over there. Okay, I'm doing a bit of damage, but I'm retreating now because I know there's... Look, there's this guy coming with the Haichi. And I know these Inquisitors will be ready for their stealth jump in a few seconds again. So what I'm trying to do right now is kind of just wait for their the next move they do. They will be jumping in a second, don't you worry about that. Oh no, I almost got him! Here, I got him now. But, yo, this was close. Uh-oh. Is that a plasma? Oh, you know what? It's a plasma guy. I can absorb the damage, no problem. And I can walk forward and backwards and make it impossible for him to hit me. And I just kill him with this. See, the ECU shield here saves my butt. There's a lot of enemies coming, oh my goodness. And everyone has a shield once again, right? Except for one guy. Like, from five enemies, only one person has no shield. You gotta be kidding me, dudes. Only one guy has no shield. Oh boy, this is crazy. I'm not sure whom to attack right now. So he's almost killed. He is killed. Wonderful. Alright. Now this guy's... Yeah, this guy's gonna be a problem because he's got Orkan rockets on him. And there's also a Fujin coming also with Orkan rockets. But I have a stealth jump back in a few seconds. So I'm trying to walk into his shield right here. I'm trying to kill him. And then, do this. Yeah! Alright, that was not a kill, but it was close enough. Let's go with this. Okay, there we go. Nice. So far, so good. Kill that Lancelot. That's right. Nice. Oh no, my Ember is reloading now. I'm getting hit so much damage from all sides, man. Oh boy. My only hope really is to try to get back into... Because we need kills, right? Keep in mind we need kills. I already lost a weapon. It's over for me, man. See, all my weapons! I don't know where they go, but they didn't hit him. All my weapons did not hit him. They went right past him somehow. Yes. No, wait. Somebody got the kill except for me. Huh, okay. Alright. 21 versus 18. It's gonna be close. It's getting closer and closer. So let's snack this guy real quick. Reloading the Taurons. And here comes an Haichi. Kill two. Another Haichi is coming. No, he was stopped. Somebody prevented this guy from getting down here. Nice. Alrighty, so 23 versus 19. We're still going here. We're still kicking it. Alright, come on. Yes, there we go. Uh-oh. An Orc Inspector jumped in. Ladies and gentlemen, we have an Orc Inspector. He's gonna jump now. Okay, here we go. Full Orc Inspector versus Taran Inspector. That is played in a different way. Different playstyle. Uh-oh. Block the Zeus. That's right. Block it. Oh, no. No, 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 no. No, we didn't think. No, that's not what I wanted to have, ladies and gents. No, 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 no. Leave me alone. Oh, my God. It feels like I'm the only person here somehow. I'm fighting the army of darkness on my own. And the specter somehow sneaks through like an ale. Like super freaking not touchable ale that you can never hit a hold. So cool. We have Orion Pax with 40 Indian rupees. He said, did you give Discord server links? I can give it again. I'm going to post the Discord group server link in a second. Wow, 2.25 million damage. Holy moly. And let's go back to free for all mode. Here's the Discord group chat link, guys. It's going to be valid for 15 minutes. Just go ahead and join right there. And I think we're switching off this thing for something else. Something that works. Do I have three redeemers? I have Ember. How many? Only two. Damn it! okay, you know what? We're gonna do this. We're gonna do Ember and Ember and Ansel Shield, okay? Let's go and do this. That's good. That's gonna be great. Alright, here comes the Ansel Shield. Where is it? Come on, show yourself, Ansel Shield. It was... Okay, there it is. Nice. Supply drops changed too. Yeah, I think you get these... hold on, let's go and check. Supply drops changed too. Who's that? Google Boss said that. Let's open two of them. We get 100 black market points for two, so 50 every four hours. That's pretty awesome, actually. 50? That's a lot. And let's go and spin that thing. Alright, here we go. We have 800. Let's spin. For 100, alright? Okay, that's 100,000 credits. Why not? Let's do it in quick. All seven. Here we go. Bam. 100,000. 250 art ballast, 100 gold, not bad, 1,000 keys, wow, 250 ion, 250 art ballast, and then a lance, no, wait, it looked like a Lancelot at first, but then, see, wow, we gotten 1,000 out of it, so that means we can now roll 1,000, okay, let's go roll the big one, no, I just rolled 10 times the 100 ones, oops. I'm sorry, guys. I failed. I wanted to run the I wanted to roll a big one, and I only got I misclicked. But yeah, damn it. Now I couldn't show you what the thousander is. God damn it! I could bite my own arse right now. All right, whatever. Let's go with this bad boy into the no. Hold on. Free for all. Yes, that's what I want. Let's go. Lucky you, do you know the way? Yeah, lucky me. But this here is the Battle Rec account. It has everything and even more. I don't need anything on this thing. That's not even my own account, right? If I get this luck on my own account, then lucky me. But on an account that isn't even my own, I think there's not that much joy in it. I wanted to show you the 1,000 bucks. That would have been really cool. So let's go and drop in with this bad boy right here. Okay, yeah, you're shooting at me right away. Okay, I see that. Let's see what this guy has. Chundun Van, or so. There's someone, but he's far away. This guy is clearly walking away from me right now. I don't need to open fire. There's no point for me in opening fire. He's probably gonna... I don't know who's gonna win this, but I'm hoping I will. And if I had open fire, then the Lancelot would be now killed by the Fury. I can't get in range though. That's my problem. I need to get a few meters further. Hopefully he's gonna try to corner shoot him. Is he going to try to corner shoot? Go back in and cover. Why are you going back behind cover? God damn it. He could have just walked behind cover, no problem, but he doesn't. Somehow he doesn't go behind cover. He just lets himself get killed. I could have sneaked both kills away. Ugh. I don't understand. He had cover in front of him and he didn't walk behind it. Why? That doesn't make any sense to me. I'm gonna, you know, use all my weapon firepower right now so I can reload. But somebody's gonna get killed there and I wanna see where he respawns. Because it could be a really problem. I think he will be respawning right there, somewhere in front of me. No? Where is he gonna drop down? This guy is right now the first, because I've only killed one guy. And the first person already has 3 kills. That's a lot of kills. He's walking away from me. Come on, dude. Why am I... Come on, I need him to walk towards me. That's what I need right now. Him to walk towards me. Not walk away from me. Now he's stationary, but look how far I have to go still. I have such a long distance to travel. But I think I can now start firing. And get him hopefully killed before the other guy does it. Nice. And he can do very little against me, because he can barely get through my Ansel shield. He probably can't. He can try to walk away, though. Damn it. Somebody came. It's the same guy again. Are you kidding me? Are you telling me this guy just happened to respawn right here? Now, that's super lucky. Hmm. What do you have right there? It's an RDB, it seems, and he doesn't want to fight a full Ansel bot. Why would he? Right? This is the problem. Now we're having a brawly bot, but we have a brawly bot that can barely get in range. We're so slow. We just can't kill anybody. See, we're just 2 meters per second more speed and we would've gotten this kill. It's just absolutely just trying to walk after kills that you're never gonna get. Ah! And he's coming now. Alright, let's grill him real quick. So now I made him stop because he saw my ember fire coming at the corner. Alright, there we- Oh, back forth. Oh man, I hate this so much. I have such hatred for this kind of move. This come out move and then dash back in move. This is so terrible, I hate it. I'm not sure if we're gonna be able to- I think we will be able to kill him, because I can draw him around the corner like this. And just hit him with massive- Oh, I lost an ember! Okay, I got him still. Whew, that was close. And we have some guy coming here, a quick Kamiho it seems. He's trying to get into my shield. The problem is he doesn't even have to. Look, because they are coming with the same weapon from all angles. Damn it. Oh, God. Really? There was the plasma bug. I saw the plasma bug, ladies and gentlemen. It still exists. The plasma bug still exists. I just saw it. Oh, dash, dash, dash. I hate it. Okay. Oh, wow, a Thunder Carnage. Wow, I'm sorry, dude, but this is crazy. Thunder Carnage can barely do a thing. So, now we managed to get the first place. It's wondersome with this machine here. It's just an absolute monster killer. Let's make him jump. If I attack him now, he will be jumping immediately. See? I knew it. I'm just gonna show him my shield and walk away. And now you're dead, dude. How's it going up there? Are you fine, huh? So, that's it for you now. That energy shield, that physical shield is just so awesome to have. I'm so happy to have this, to come up with this, because kind of, I've never seen this being used by anybody. It's just something that I've only seen like by on my account so far. And I enjoy playing it so much, because it requires a bit more skill to use the shield more. Yeah, he doesn't want to get close, because if he gets close, there's another Inquisitor jump coming. And right now, my most logical choice to do is not get close. I cannot kill that full Leo within my alpha damage. I can't kill him fully. But I can wait to sneak a kill. Now he's kind of, now he's in a, you know, he has to do something right now. Maybe I can attack that Inquisitor? No. He has to do something. And since he's going to be victorious, I'm actually going for the Inquisitor first, making him jump. There it is. See that? I knew that was going to happen. I knew he was going to jump. I'm trying to wait for my chance to get the kill steal. No! Aww! How did that happen? I planned my damage. Okay. Oh, so quick. Oh no, it's an RDB, no. Oh, he has 500 meters range. Oh, it could have been everything now, just no RDB. That's the worst thing he could have come with. And it is an RDB, of course. Oh, freaking heck. And then he has the range advantage on me here too. But I got him, that was close. Lost my physical shield, even though I wasn't even using it. What? Stop saying that you can put an Ancel on the middle. Oh, you guys mean the Ember, right? The Ember Fury? There is a reason why I'm going with the Ember on both on the same side. Because what you do when you play the game, you know, when you try to make the maximum efficiency out of your robot, when you try to make it run as effective as possible, then you're also going to be using corner shooting. You will be sticking out two weapons out of the corner, and then you just fire at the enemy. Like I did against that Lancelot that was coming around, and I just walked back around the corner, reversed, and fired around the corner. I couldn't have done that if the third weapon would have been here. You need to have them both at the same side, so you can most effectively corner shoot. And that's why I went with the Ancel shield on the outside. Of course, in some situations, that means I can't corner shoot because the enemy is coming from the left side. But what I will do is I'm gonna look for opportunities to use the right side, right? So that's why, on purpose, there is the Ancel shield on one side. Alright, we have right here... I couldn't walk for some reason. You're getting attacked now from behind. Oh god, did you see what happened? I was stuck at the wall up there. I wanted to sneak the kill away, and it didn't work because my bot jumped into the wall, into this ceiling thing above me, and no movement happened. Oh god, I can't believe that just really happened there. Yes, of course! You with your one Taran shot gets the kill. God damn it! Incredibly unlucky right now. Okay. Let's regenerate. I have to reload the Scourge. I would have totally gotten this kill on the Haichi there. I would have gotten it if this bot wouldn't have jumped against this thing above me. There we go. Look from which angle I'm coming. I'm coming from so far up. So insane. Alright, this is like a real sniper right now. This Griffin. Sorry, Raven. Don't you love it when you can't hit the enemy, but those weird Comijos can still somehow get you? I don't think I'll get the kill because, you know, somebody else is gonna get me. It's from now from behind, and then he's gonna sneak this guy's kill away. Kill enemy in Hell Drive in Free For All. Ballista. Oh yeah, we're gonna run the Ballista too. That's right, we haven't run the Ballista yet, but we will. Don't worry. Alright, got this kill. I'm going to, just for good measure, reload my Tyrants because it's, you know, useful to do that. Then I'm going to walk towards this Bulgazari right here. And then say hi there. Hello darkness, my old... Oh my god! How? He's going to aim at me now. Whoop. And of course. You know, that's what happens on Free For All. If you try to use a little bit of skill and try to be careful, try to be, you know, aware of everything, you're just gonna get killed by it from behind. You don't have the time in many situations to run things like that. Oh, now I made a mistake. I made a mistake, a terrible mistake. His stealth ability will run out before mine. See, now I could fire at him. I could be shooting him now, and I messed it up. My jump should have ended right next to him. Then I would have had the advantage. He's gonna jump in 3, 2, 1, jump. Seems like he jumped against the wall. See that? Oh, now I'm jumping. So now I've got him. There we go. Oh my god, come on! Dude, I'm using my energy shield, my physical shield again to block somebody's damage. What happens? Some other dude just comes, whoops you. No problem, man. I think Moon is too small for this. There's no way to actually block some kind of damage or play skillful here. You're just gonna get whooped from behind immediately. See, I barely spawned in my bot, and it takes like 2 seconds for some goo to just come up and kill me. Attack me here. Because the map is so small. I really think Moon, either the spawns have to be made a little bit better, because this is like, this is the new fresh version of Free Fall, so some things may not be perfectly optimized yet, and I think the spawn points on Moon are very frustrating right now. I think frustrating is the right word to use here. So, hi there. Oh man, that was crazy. And, I guess he's gonna spawn right behind me or something. But I can't use any know-how to block some of the damage. Alright, I got him pretty good right there. He's coming again. He wants it. So, he's going to dash now. No, he's not going to dash, it seems. Okay. He feels safe. He doesn't know I'm right behind him, above him here. He has no idea I'm here. And there we go. He paid his attention to the other enemy, and then when I started moving, so he had no idea. There is my next enemy right there. Bulgazaris are really easily killed with this setup here. Now he's gonna dash. Now he's gonna try to dash again. There it is. Of course it was gonna happen. And there we go. Nice. Rampage. Whew. Now I go back and kill the other guy. What the heck? They're spawning every time they're spawning on the other side. I just walk to the other side and kill the next dude. What is this? It's a Lancelot with Shock Train and Zeus. Interesting. Unfortunately, I do not have the ability to block weapon damage, so I have to walk across into his range right now. There we go. There is nothing I can do about it now. I had to walk right through his firing line, otherwise I would have not made it onto the platform, right? I had to make sure that my jump is gonna get far enough to land on the platform. So I can already corner shoot with the rockets and the ember. What I'm doing right now, regenerating some Orkin firepower. There's somebody wants to sneak in the kill, I think. Yeah, he's not coming anymore because he knows what would happen if he did. Alright, there we go. And kill stolen, okay. Now, this guy is going to be a problem. I can't kill him anymore. It's too much. But we still have this guy here. Alright, there he goes. No, of course not. Of course not. There we go. 1 HP left, yes. Alright, I'm reloading now. So let's see who's gonna win this. He will try to come into my shield. I have a lot of firepower with a double ember right now. And he was defeated. Nice. The double ember on the Fury is really a deadly machine, ladies and gentlemen. It's pretty crazy. Uh-oh. There he is. You know, let me act like I was firing at somebody else. That means he's gonna come, see? If he sees me shooting into another direction, and he will come. But what is it that he has? Oh boy. Okay, I have no chance. It's a specter with oh man, completely squished between everybody right there. Hmm. Update later for iOS. Kid Killer 79 says. Okay, so you know that it's gonna come later, or oh, you mean it will just be delayed compared to Android? Yeah, yeah. That is definitely it's always like that. They always have the update first on. Yo, see, that was good. I was able to drop his shield without actually using any of my I didn't even use my weapons for it really, because. That second dash was not so good, because it allowed me to get right here. Money, you should use 4x Gecko on a pattern. Well, could do. Totally my kill. Yes. That was legitimately my kill. No one else had a taps on this one. Of course, yes. I totally deserved it. So let's see what they have right there. Oh, okay. As always, I'm waiting for the last possible split second. Do you see that? I'm waiting for the last possible split second to activate my jump ability, because this way I can have it ready my stealth. Oh really? Oh, that dash completely. No! That one dash took everything away. This kill was just completely stolen from me. Because this one dash. Ugh. But yeah, if a specter jumps at you, and I think you will have that very often from now on, this situation. If that's a specter will jump at you. Just make sure to, where is he? He's right there, okay. Just make sure to wait with your stealth ability till the very last moment. And if you do this, you'll basically make it so that you have your stealth ability still running when his ability is out, and that will give you the kill. Alrighty. Oh, I hated to get kill stolen. Like, if I do 99% damage, it has this Haichi had 1% health. 1% dashes into safety, gets killed by somebody else. Ah. You guys will hate that too. I promise you guys. You guys will hate that so much in the free for all game mode. But at the same time, you're probably gonna love it when you do it yourself. When is Skirmish coming? Dennis Chen is asking. That is a really good question, guys. I don't know the answer to this one. When does the event start, Manny? What event? The Free For All? It's already running. Free For All is already going, if you mean that as an event. I want to use the Bulgazari with a new ballista weapon, but at first I need a long range map for that. Okay, we have. Wow! He pretty much one-hitted me right here. He pretty much one-hit killed me right here. Wow, dude! He came in from behind so nicely, dude. I had no chance. By the time I realized what was going on, I was half dead already. Okay, I'm gonna fire empty the Scourge. Okay. He had 1%. The same guy, 1% health. That was all he had left. But it was enough. It was enough to get killed by somebody else, and now I have 0 kills. Gosh darn it, man. According to 3.8, the Skirmish should be live right now. Paumia Gaming says that. Paumia Gaming. Huh. Okay, interesting. Ah. I tried so hard. Wait, what? What was with my second jump? You saw my second jump just went completely into nowhere? What the heck? I did a jump and it didn't work. That was a bug report right there. Huh, somehow it did not work. All right, whatever. What is he coming with? Oh, yeah, sure. I totally have a chance right here. Everyone wants me because I'm so low on health now. Alright, I'm getting Jack. Yeah! Nice, there we go. Haichi bites the dust. The problem is, though, that he... First off, he's still first. And secondly, he has a shock drain, Bulgazari. So, there goes my chance. Okay, I know these guys have both... They both are running Bulgazaris right now, so I could really do a lot if I just get close to these guys. But look how far away they are. They're literally on the other side of this frickin' planet. You gotta be kidding me, dude. Look how far I have it just to get there. So there goes my kill. What?! You got the kill! You got the kill with your ridiculously low firepower compared to this. Wow, this is just a really ridiculous right now. I can't believe he just took that kill. His hit points was going and he somehow made the kill in between. Whoa. Alright, whoa, we have a one coming in here. I don't even see it on my, on the setting thing here yet. Alright, you know what, I have to concentrate right now on Lord. And I have a Zeus Fury coming from the other side. So I was able to... See, there he goes. There goes his shield. And since he just dropped his shield, I'm gonna just do this. Boom. I dropped his shield at first, and then he used both dashes. He shouldn't have double dashed. The second dash was his big mistake. He couldn't get behind cover and evade my rockets anymore. There's two stealth dudes pummeling each other right there. Not sure if they're in line of... No, they have no line of sight with each other because they're not attacking. They are damaging each other, but they're not killing each other yet. Okay, man, now you could... So, that's it for you. Okay. I know there's another Haichi coming up. Once again, I'm doing the same thing right here. I'm dropping this energy shield of his, so I can just... What's hitting me? Is that Hydra? Something came in from above somehow, weird. Oh, there we go. Oh, kill. Nice. Another donation popping in. Ladies and gents, I need to read them. Give me a second, okay? I will read them in a second. I just need to first... What is this guy using? It's Hydra. Yeah. Who was that? So I'm blocking the Hydra damage with this. Okay, I'm trying to walk into his shield here to kill him super fast right this, because he won't be able to shoot with his Hydra. He first has to lock on. There's another Spectre coming in. Oh man, I'm in trouble, dude. There's so many dudes coming. I won't be able. No, I only had 2 seconds left on the stealth ability. No. Alright, you know what? Let's just read what was happening here. I am Yellow Snow donated another 10 bucks. On Facebook Game Room, we have the reload button for months. What the heck? Really? Is that really true? I want the reload button too. What the heck? Why did you get the reload button and we didn't get it? That's weird. Alright, and the next one was eine kleine Spende. Hast du auch Probleme mit dem Emulator? Splexigens gave me a little donation right there. He says a little tip, kind of. And did you also have problem? Wait, what? I thought he has Tyrants. The reason why I showed my flank and corner shooted was because I thought he has Tyrants. He has Orkans. he has the counter to corner shooting. And I stand there like a freaking moron and show him my side, let him completely splash into me the whole freaking time. Wow, I'm such a tool right now. So before my stealth ability drops, I purposely made a jump so that I know I can just drop behind cover. Rockets again. Wow, dude. Now he gets the second kill too. I prepared him and now he's getting this other kill too. No. Wait a minute, they were both really low on HP. So, yeah, there was this update had some problems, but, you know, we got a fix for it, and that's great. We can continue running this this game mode here, the game on the way we did it before, and that's really good. I'm glad we do. I thought he was gonna come right now. I really thought he would. Oh, man. So many specters. And of course, now you can benefit from the rockets that he damaged. And now you can come in. Dude, am I the only person here? Like, what is going on? Look. And I was unable to kill him. Dude, he has like 1%. Look, that's his health. That was his health. I'm so sick of this. This is so, like, seriously, man. Come on, dude. This is so sickening. I had two specters coming at me. Haichi and Spectre and Inquisitor, the Lancelot. Everyone came just for me right here. Oh boy. Nobody went for anybody else. Ugh. I wanted to do something with my bot. I wanted to do something and not just get whooped by in a 3-on-1. But that's what happened. 3-on-1. In a free-for-all game mode. Even though I had full health, I had an energy shield, I had full HP. Normally you go for low HP bots, and not those who just have completely full HP. I'm reloading my weapons now. Thanks to the fact that I have this shield, I don't have to be afraid of this thing right there. He has 300 meters range. He still got me. Yeah, sure. I didn't turn in my shield. No, I didn't. Everyone could see that I had my shield turned sideways. There's some input delay that drives me nuts. Oh, you also have it, huh? I thought you don't have the stealth jump right now. Alright, I got him before he got me. That was close. Ugh! Shake it off. Shake it off and kill the enemy. What do they have there? An Inquisitor. Let me try to make him jump. See, there it is. That was easy. That was so easy. I just made him jump. It was the easiest thing in the world. Probably because the time was running out anyways. Okay. Phew. I love it. I love running around with this and playing Free For All. It's such a fun game mode, guys. Really, I'm not sure if you are on iOS and you don't have the app update yet, it will come very soon and you're gonna have so much fun with this Free For All game mode. Because finally, you don't have to actually, you don't have to be the best player. You need to get the kills. Look at this. Ha ha. Look what I just did with him. Did you see that? I changed my flight direction in mid-air. And that's why he... Oh no, really? He spawned here now. Now that's bullcrap. Now that's bullcrap. You shouldn't be spawning 1 meter next to me, dude. Should still be able to kill him. Yep. Nice. The Griffin works. The Raven, sorry. But that's what they meant with when they said they wanted to implement more skillful play abilities, like this double jump, where you can now, in mid-air, change your direction. And this is a really, really useful thing. I'm going to lose this. I have no chance. There's way too much firepower on this Haichi. Alright, there we go. Another height, she bites the dust. Next time we get a long range map, I'm gonna use the ballista gate, guys, okay? Mark 2, level 12 ballista. Times 3. That will be crazy. I think that's the Haichi from before. Is it low health? Give me that kill. No! It's physical pain. It's really physical pain I feel when this happens. It's so terrible. Just walk forward. Get that kill. Come on. It's so impossible. Oh, god damn it, man. See how freaking nerve-wracking this is. It is so... there was a guy who was like a one-hit kill. And I didn't attack him. Alright, I won't be able to kill him, I think. Yeah, he got me still. But you will feel that pain too, guys, when you play this game mode and you notice how freaking crazy the enemies are just kill-stealing everything you do. Wow, that was a full Bulgazari right there. Oh, man. Where's that flame stuff coming from? Who's firing these flames? This guy. Wow, half my HP gone before I could even do anything. Double dash, yes. Now he's low HP and he will just... You will get killed from behind. Oh, I got it. Okay. I thought this guy will just get killed from behind by this other dude. I really saw it coming. There's an Inquisitor. What the heck? We're all Inquisitor. Ha ha. I'm up on this thing. Oh, no. I got it. Yes. Damn it. It's not working. The shield is not working against Ember. And now it's gone anyways, and oh man. Oh, freaking crazy. This is so much kill-stealing left and right. Everybody is just kill-stealing everybody's kill. Just, wow. Dominique is here. Hey, Dominique. Welcome, dude. So what do we have there? Something with Orkans. It's a Kamiho. Uh-huh. He dashed twice, but you know what? Kamiho, that doesn't mean anything. He just used most of his rockets. Of course! Oh, for God's sakes, you can't catch them. They will move 300,000 kilometers in like 2 seconds or so. Of course you get this kill! Of course! With your instant damage delivery weapon. It's just a damage delivery system, what this is. That's the freaking shock drain, dude. A damage delivery system. Boop! Half the HP on the enemy is gone. And I had to jump now. I was forced to jump. Now he has me. Okay, why did you jump now? Now you're landing. What the heck was that? He had me. He had me in completely free without any chance. And now he made this mistake of walking here. Are you kidding me? Now you still killed me? Oh my god, look at his health. Yeah, shock train. It's just on every level this weapon is outperforming everything because of this instant damage. Boom, 500 meters. Poof, one hit kill. You can use it so well to kill steal enemies' kills. All you have to do is just wait for the HP to be gone and kill. Stolen. There we go. I knew it was going to take a lot of damage, but if I hadn't been offensive, he would have just killed me very defensively, because I really, as a matter of fact, I don't really have much of a chance against him. There's an Haichi coming around the corner. See, and that's what I mean. This is the corner shooting that I meant before, guys. See, there's the Haichi's coming. I'm just trying to walk around the corner and corner shoot kill. Boom. I couldn't have done that if my weapons would have been located to the right and to the left. I needed to have it like this. Oh man, what am I gonna do with this bot now? Yeah, this is gonna be super powerful. Somebody wants to kill me. It's that Spectre. He will probably jump stealth. Stealth jump, I mean. See, there he is. And if he does, then he's now used his stealth jump ability. And if I'm lucky, I drop in... Nah, I'm not lucky. Okay. If I had been lucky, I would have been able to drop next to him. And I would have been able to just kill him now with my stealth jump, right? What does he have? I didn't want to use my stealth ability here because I need it for this guy. For this guy, I need the stealth jump. And he's also playing very careful. He's not coming out. He's now corner shooting me, basically. There is no progress. There's not going to be any progress here. Because if I stealth jump first... There we go. He did not expect the damage to come in from behind. That was my blessing here. He had no... Because I saw what was going on behind him. He couldn't look behind him, so I knew he was gonna lose a lot of health in a few seconds. Like, in 3 seconds, 3, 2, 1, you're gonna lose a lot of health. And I just used that moment really quickly there. And made use of it. There we go. Alright, let's see how much we can do with this one Spectre that we have right now. I'm not sure. We're down to very low HP, and there's another Spectre coming up. You know what? I need him to jump at me like this, but the problem is he's gonna get me now. Yep. I needed 2 more seconds. If I had 2 more seconds, I could have walked back and behind the cover there, and that would have secured the victory. Damn it. I was planning so that I reverse when he activates his jump, I reverse and go behind cover and make him waste his jump. Unfortunately, I was out of range from my building. My safe building was 2-3 meters too far away, and this whole situation did not work anymore. He got him. I was hoping he wouldn't, but he did. Five, four, three, two, one, and jump. Almost. Yeah, got him. Yes, gotcha in midair, dude. There we go. That's what I planned on doing. I was hoping he would jump at the same... I knew he was going to jump at the same time. And then it was just gonna a matter of aligning the firepower so that I can hit him in midair. That was really cool. 11 versus 14. We had a really good player on the other side. This guy knew how to play Spectres. That's for sure. And one thing is also for sure. On this game mode, enemies don't run out of... what is it? They don't run out of... Come on, help me out. Out of bots, because they can just reinforce the bots again and bring them back and back. Pop that beer out of the fridge, Manny. Rich-ass junkie said that. I'm playing Team Deathmatch now because I wanna use this thing now. The Bulgazari with the new ballista weapon. Mark II, level 12 ballista times 3. On this bad boy here. Boom! Yeah, not bad. Not bad. He has 600 meters range. Oh, we have one coming in from Dominique. Oh, wow. Hold on, Dominique, we're gonna read this in a second. Let me reload and... fire. Boom. Wait a minute, you just... what? Are you shooting like... what are you shooting with? You're not dealing any damage? Anyways, and there goes the kill. Boom. So you can see the damage output of this, of the ballista is quite good at Mark II level 12. But, and it reloads much faster than the trebuchet does. But of course, with less damage. See, that was a fully charged triple version of the of this weapon. And the damage was moderate. We did like 20% damage to that griffin. Boom, boom, boom. Nice. So what was Dominique sending? Get well soon, Adrian. Oh yeah, Dominic M is saying something, that's right. I'm not sure if you noticed, but Adrian isn't uploading or isn't doing so many live streams right now. It's because when he came back from his trip to Russia, he had this, he caught some kind of flu or something with, like, bronchitis or something. And he was quite down. And, so, I need to say get well soon better, Adrian, and, hopefully you're feeling better really, really soon. There was a lot of people who were kind of worried about your disappearance all of a sudden, because we knew you were going to be back from Russia, but then we didn't hear anything. I'm not sure if he's even here, Adrian, but if so, then... boom. Boom. The Trident Fury. Bye-bye. But look how he just depleted half my bot's health with his one attack. That was crazy. Oh man, I just saw a Spectre. Another Spectre. Oh, frickin' hey. Uh-oh, no, I almost, I could hit him. Oh, that was so close, I could have almost hit him there. Like, blind shooting. Ugh, it's always too late. Every time you see it, you see the shock train come around the corner, it's too late to turn around, you already have the damage. But hey, we can run this thing. Yeah. Let's run this weird-looking Natasha with an ECU shield and Gecko. So, question is it going to be worth it? Are we going to be able to do anything with it? That's going to be the question here. Wow, I can fire over this. Hold on, there is somebody. They killed each other right there. Come on, die already. Jesus Christ. Oh my goodness, that shield. Look at that shield. It's just endlessly absorbing damage. In the meantime, I'm getting killed by rockets everywhere because I'm focusing on this thing. So skillless. Just dodge forward and hit the button. The weapon auto targets. You don't have to aim after your enemy. You just hit the button and without zero skill, just kill the enemy. No problem. Ugh. Shock Train is just the worst piece of crap they've ever put into this game. I wish they would remove it. It just failed. Shock Train has failed. Has failed War Robots. Team play is getting destroyed by it. You can no longer stick together because the freaking chain damage. And this absolute insane, how you call it? Like, everything is so perfect on this weapon, right? Lock on conveniently at 600 meters. Get in range and hit the button. Instantly deal full damage. Bypass energy shields. Never miss. It's just too much. The weapon is just too good. By so many, you know, on so many levels. I wonder if I ever get in range. Okay, here we go. I should be getting him now, but of course he's also dashing away. I knew he was gonna dash away. I'm hoping I will eventually catch this guy. Jesus, he just moves 700 kilometers in like 2 seconds. Ugh. Okay, got this kill before I died. So, let's see what we can use here. Okay, that was worthless. Using these rockets was worthless. I wonder if they're gonna kill him. Alright, they got him. Nice. There's a Lancelot with Orkans. And see what he's coming with? Oh my goodness. He's coming with an Haichi with Orkans because I have a Rhino. Oh, he just counters me. That's all he does. He just comes in with the hard counter and that's it. Oh, I know what you have because I saw you before, so what I'm gonna do now, I'm just gonna come with this one thing that you cannot have a chance against. Oh, it's so annoying. Yeah. Sure, I have to retarget. You see how I retarget now? Huh. So there goes this guy. We're losing, by the way. We're losing big time. Okay, I'm not sure where to go right now. Damn it, I missed. And he hasn't fired yet. He has only one of them used so far. Now he's fired. Okay. They are totally in the lead right now. Damn it. Somehow I lost my shield. I'm taking a lot of damage. Okay, okay. So far, I'm still alive at least. I'm trying to have him targeted so that when this guy appears, I can immediately target him. I need the double dash. I need double dash. Oh boy. Okay. Thankfully, we were able to absorb this one. This is crazy right now. We have our last butt. I'm using my last butt right now. Stupid. Nice. Okay, there he goes. This guy with his freaking Hydras and Spirals, it's just relentless. He is just relentless with this stuff. Nice, I made him jump early. Damn it. That was not so nice. So he's gonna stealth jump in a second again. Okay, this guy is dead, but I don't think we still have a chance here. I don't know how he got me there. In my opinion, there was a building in front of us. Okay, we had some stuff coming in. Oh, whoa, wait a minute. Superhead 408 just whooped a $42 donation right in and just made our live stream 1 hour longer, hey? Extra hour, here's to your war robot friend Adrian getting better soon. Absolutely, man. Absolutely. Adrian, we're all wishing you the best. And yeah. But I think he's already feeling better than he was when he came back. So it's getting better. We know that it's better, getting better. It's not like, I don't think it's super serious anymore. If the way I got it. So calm down, guys. He's not, you know, I think he's going to be okay. It's just, it will just take him a little while. But hey, thank you, my friend. Much appreciated, dude. Let's, yeah, we're going to leave. We're going to lose this battle anyways, because we don't need to wait 40 seconds. But finally, we've seen the Ballista Mark II in action, guys. That was cool. And Ketil Kronberg says, and here we see Manny in his natural habitat, being very weird and being very triggered about dashbots. Yes. I hate them. I think dashbots. Well, actually, dashbots aren't the worst. If it was just dashbots, it would be good. What makes it crazy if you combine dashbots with certain special weapons, right? Shock train, for example. The combination out of these two things is nothing. It's just ugh. It's just too crazy. But it's not particularly the dashbot itself. It's a combination thing out of both things. Yeah, you know what he's doing right now? He's regenerating his stealth jump. Yeah, I got it. So that once... Oof. Corner shoot, corner shoot. Ha, how you like that? Oh no. Oh boy. Ah, damage from behind. Frickin' Haichi coming out of nowhere. No, leave me alone. No, no, no. Ah, okay. You know what? That was it. 200 Indian rupees. I'm not even sure how much that is. Says from Orion PAX 27. I'm gonna read it in a second. Hold on. I need to whoop that guy. I think it's in Haichi. Pretty sure it's in Haichi. It has an energy shield and it's walking relatively fast. Can only be in Haichi. I think it might be an orc in Haichi. Because. This guy has relatively low health. He could be snacked really quickly. Damn it. I knew that was gonna happen. Nice, I got him. Okay. And now that Haichi is also taking some good hits. Oops, I'm not reloaded yet. He seems to be AFK or something. I'm not sure. I had to reload. Oh, Plasma Buck still exists. See, Plasma Buck. Zero damage. I cannot deal damage to him. It's impossible. I mean... Does it get any more obvious than this? Because he had the ground behind him from this up angle, I was completely unable to deal any point of damage. I have launched my YouTube channel on my name based on Warrobots. Thanks for the inspiration. I will make sure that I never miss the fun watching you a million subscribers. Well, I can't imagine that happening. But thank you, my friend, and good luck with your YouTube channel. Why not go ahead and check him out a little bit, guys? You could go and check him out and see what he offers. He will get attacked from behind now. So I'm reloading now. Hopefully I get the kill. There it is. Nice, I got it. Somebody else... Oh, see? There was the rocket coming from someone else. They wanted it. Oh, there's an RDB Griffin. You're gonna shoot in the ground. I know you will. So there's another RDB Griffin. Wow, there's tons of RDB Griffins. And I can literally not walk into safety. He will get me. There is nowhere to go. Uh-oh, I have to reload now. Hopefully this thing protects me. What is going on? Is he losing connection? He seems to be losing connection right now. Yeah, that was the only reason why I was able to survive this, because he kind of lost connection. And I'm even getting another kill with an 8,000 HP bot. What? Really? Okay. Whatever you say. That was good. That was really cool. And hey, man, once again, wait, his name changed. Suithead 804. Is it just me or did that name just change? Suithead for... Oh no, that was a kill that I didn't see. Oh no, and I got killed. I didn't see. Oops. Playing like a maniac. What is this? Okay, it's a normal griffin. Oh, I got the... Wow, okay. I did not expect that. I thought I was gonna, you know, miss everything right there. So let's walk towards that Zeus Fury over there. Hi. This guy. Hi. Okay. Okay. He's already trying to shoot me. Where are you? What kind of freaky position is this? I can't even get up to him. What an amazing position he has. Ah, he's shooting me from above. Nice. Snuck. Mine. So, how you feeling, dude? See that? And that's this physical shield. He can literally not do a thing. Alright. I pushed him into the corner. Oh man, too good. Of course I drop my shield now significantly, right? It's really down. Uh-oh, this is a Bulgazari. Nah, he's getting killed from behind now. You're gonna get killed from behind. Look behind you, dude. Oh, you're not gonna kill from behind. Oh, no, you got me. Oh, boy. Okay. See, that's the problem with the Spectre. You have so much health. You get dropped in a second. You will get killed your entire bot in a few seconds, and that's the problem with this thing. Give me that kill. Yes? Sorry. That's my kill now. I totally deserve it. So, what's going on? Anyone? Any more enemies here? I think I killed 9 enemies. And, oops. You know what? I got a little problem right there, because this Bulgazari Scourge has much more range than I do. And although I can counter his physical shield with my weapons, he can counter me with a range. I'm just slowly making my way. There we go. Alright, let's reload this weapon. He might be respawning in something. Oh, 2 guys! We have 2 new enemies. Okay. That was unexpected. I need my full weapons for it. To deal with this, this Haichi. Oh, the other person is already behind me. Wow. I don't need to open fire. Forget it. There's no point in firing right now. The other guy will just get him. Look, the other person is not even he's not even doing something. He's just waiting for his kill steal opportunity. So look, both of them are firing at me now because they can't do a thing to each other. Yeah. That's what it comes down to at the end. They both had an energy shield. I didn't have an energy shield and the Orkan rockets, and that made me the target. Simple as that. I even had a good amount of health, but I was target. With no shield, no means of absorbing damage, I'm the target. Problem. But that's, you know, if you run energy shield, then the other guy would have maybe been targeted from behind. I couldn't get into safety anymore, that's the problem. 1 minute left on the clock, wow, dude. That's very little time for this slow thing that I'm running right now. Yeah, I'm not sure if he's also losing connection or what the heck is going on, but I think it would have probably been a little bit smarter if he had just, you know, not died for no reason. And now, once again, I'm in the middle of everybody right now. And I will get just killed. There's nothing I can do. He will just drop my shield and the other guy will come in and kill me. He had to use both dashes to get there, so I was able to do this. But now I have a problem. Now, thankfully, I had an energy shield this time. Oh boy. I'm reloading. Ah! The match is over. Ha! He wasn't able to get me anymore. Yoo-hoo! I like the Carnage better myself. Logos Sue says. Oh, by the way, I've got messages on on YouTube. Yeah. People saying, hey, why would you run two dragoons or no? Why would you run 2 embers and an answer shield? Why would you run 2 thunders and an answer shield on the Fury? Just take a Carnage. You're faster and you have the same stuff. No, you don't have the same stuff. You have no answer. Wait a minute, this answer shield is only level 10? That's why I have so low HP. I was wondering, normally it's more than 100,000, so why was it so little? I seem to have my other Ansel shield equipped somewhere. I don't know where it is. But you know, maybe we can bring this up. Here, life, I don't know. I'm not sure if I'm gonna be able to afford this. Nope, see, that's I don't have enough. But basically, you have, with the Ansel shield, with a real Ansel shield, Mark II, level 12 or whatever, you have 100, I don't know, 18,000 or so shield energy. Compared to our Carnage, it has way less. 70,000, 80,000, I'm not sure, or 90, so, way less. And then you have 228,000 HP in armor on this Fury too, where the Carnage has... barely more than 100,000 or something, 150 or so, 160, I'm not entirely sure, but you have so much more health, right? And the biggest danger to an Carnage is always plasma, and the Fury just can't take so much damage before he goes down. He's a little fortress. And that's why the Fury with Carnage, the Fury with Ember and Ansel is way more powerful than a Carnage with Ember. Simply because you have so much more health to trade with. We need a heavy Hydra. Oh, I disagree. I'm not sure if we really need a heavy Hydra. Although, heavy Hydra, yeah, the problem is that, you know, the Hydras are already pretty powerful, and if you have those at a long range on a heavy weapon platform with a heavy weapon damage output, it's going to be ridiculous. Like, the amount of damage output you can inflict without showing yourself is going to be so high. Alright, so they have already gotten half the points out of it, damn it. Before we even have a chance to get some big points out of this, they already have it. Come on, turn around and hit that guy. What are you doing? Why are you walking in a circle? This guy next to me is just walking in a circle for some weird reason. Oh wait, the next beacon is above us, apparently. Unfortunately, we're unable to get this beacon. Because above us is this other guy. Alright, I'm trying to get him, but, you know, no time, no chance. I'm trying to get into the Ansel shield of the Haichi. We have an Haichi behind us. And I'm trying to be inside that shield to be protected from his rockets. But, oh yeah, now another Ansel shield is saving me right now. You notice that? The Haichi had another Ansel shield put up, so another bot came in or something. Thankfully, we got the beacon now, and I already know which one will activate next. You see it right there. It's next to the enemy base. And I don't think we're gonna be able to get this, because look, there's already three enemies going for it. So, I don't think it makes sense to try to go for this beacon. We should probably try to see what we can do in regards to the one coming after. Probably more worth it. So I'm outside of his weapon range. He's got 300 and I'm at way more range than that. So he just took a whole bunch of damage for no reason. I just walked backwards and he fired everything into the wall. Now maybe I can bait him again. So they're now going to get this beacon, but which... Oh, see, this beacon is now active. Ha! Because they took it immediately. Here we go. Let's try to bait him into coming out. Oh, he's not coming. I'm looking to the left and to the right, making sure there's no one making some freaking surprises for me. Alright, we got this beacon, and the enemy is already on the next one, wherever it is. I'm not even sure where the other beacon is. Ah! Well, I know where this beacon is now. Damn it. Okay, here we go. Nah, I'm gonna die. Frickin' heck. I need some backup. 2 versus 4 under the bridge. No chance. I was trying to go into there, in there, and use my stealth jump, and but my stealth jump on the Spectre doesn't last long enough, and yeah, they're gonna easily dominate us there. Oh, I know which beacon comes next. This one right here. Yoo! This is so cool. The Raven, man. It's so cool to just jump in from so far away and somehow land. I think the Raven is now pretty much the fastest enemy on site. The fastest guy on site is now the Raven. Walking backwards, always walking backwards against Aphid's Vortex. That will give you a better chance. Next time he fires, I'm gonna try to take him out. Oh, I made a mistake here. Damn it. I made a really bad mistake. Oh no! Oh man. I wanted to double jump and my second jump was not yet ready. That was my mistake. My mistake was I wasn't ready with a second jump. So I couldn't connect. I couldn't connect the first jump with the second jump. And that was it. GG. Oh man, I just never get him in range. It's just always this gap. It's always there. This freaking tiny gap that completely blocks my damage all the time. Drives me nuts. Three jumps long, I had this gap blocking my damage. So the next one is gonna be the middle one now. Trying to go in range here. Oh man, what the heck did I just do? I freaking turned super stupid thing I just did. No reason for this weird turnaround. I should have just held up my shield and walked the other direction. If you have a physical shield to the left, walk to the right and have the physical shield the way where the rockets come from. You will not take any damage. Zero damage, that's what you're gonna take. Workshop 2.0 is not yet in the game, I haven't seen it yet, guys. ASS Boss says, "Hey Manny, I've been here since the very beginning. Love your videos." Thank you, man. Much appreciated, buddy. So, what are we gonna pick? We could use this hangar too. Yeah, let's go for it. Let's go and use this hangar. Hi. He's gonna dash. There it is. There's the dash and another dash. And now he just gets killed by somebody else. Look. He will just get killed by someone else now because he just dashed away. I really want that kill. Oh, come on, dude. Oh, it's just relentlessly trying to get in. Somehow I get in firing range. Okay, I got it. Wait. Oh, okay. Somebody else got this one then. Okay, let's try to get close to this Bulgazari shock train. He's gonna dash. See? I knew he was gonna dash. I just saved my rockets for him there. He will dash again in a second, but yeah, hopefully I'll get the kill. Oh, I did get the kill, but it was the last possible split second, guys. One more second and I wouldn't have gotten it. The reason why I dropped into this Lancelot right here is because I knew many enemies will be running Bulgazari shock trains. Like, see, you can see so many of them. So many of these Bulgazari shock trains are coming. And that's why I chose to go with this setup. Boom. Another kill. Oh, you got some cover, don't you? Well, this is an Inquisitor, so he will be able to just jump at me. I'm gonna try to stay safe from that for now. Corner shoot, force him into... Wait, what? Oh, frick. I could have gotten him. I could have totally gotten him there, but you know what? Now I have my Ansel shield no more, and my thunder. That means I cannot bring down his shield at long range. Oh well, go. We were running a different hangar this time. Let's see how effective it will be. One more shot, come on. Nice, okay, I got him. Yo, this is... He was way too close. Sniper setups don't really work when you were that close to the enemy. I knew he was gonna attack now. I'm waiting for my chance to whoop the kid. Oh, freaking heck. Ugh. I miscalculated. I should have gotten him there, but I miscalculated my shot. Double kill. Everyone is staying behind Carver now. Look, everyone is super... Ah, there he is. Alright, I got him, but he's going to come closer to me now. He's going to try to cross the distance towards me. And he doesn't want to get in firing range while doing that, so that's my problem. Let's try to make him think I'm firing at something else. It didn't work, okay. Oh, freaking double dash. So now what? What are we doing? Gonna do now? There we go. Okay. I thought he was gonna camp around the corner the whole time now. I probably wouldn't have gone in like he just did. Oh no, a Lancelot. That's a problem. And he even has this column now. He even found this column to walk up the... Just walk up the ramp, for love of God. I have absolutely no cover. I broke through his physical shield, though. His physical shield is now broken. And he's taking major damage from this Haichi. There we go. Haha! Nice. Kill steal. And another kill steal. Wow, dude, it's going crazy. The Natasha with dragoons. Who would have thought this thing would be so powerful in free for all? I think I killed most enemies right now with a Natasha and dragoon. That's insane. So he's got 350 meters range and he's got Tyrants. And Rampage! A full Haichi coming around, man. This is just too awesome. And there he is again. Dropping in again with another bot. Maybe I can kill steal this guy. If I just wait for the right moment. No, I don't think I will. And you got me. Wonderful. He's literally not doing anything but focusing me now. Hmm. Wait a minute. This physical shield, I think... No, it's not broken. Come on, die. You can't bypass that freaking thing. No, one more shot. One more shot. That was all I needed. Oh, god damn it. That was freaking unlucky as heck. So I'm waiting here. Yup, there it is. I kill steeled that thing completely with this weapon. And he's super mad now. He lost that kill for no reason. I'm attacking the other guy. I'm purposely not attacking him, I'm purposely attacking the other guy because this way I might have a chance to once again kill steal that. Yes! Did you see that? Oh man, he must be so mad. He must be so freaking mad, man. I just come in and just kill steal every little thing. Everything he does, he works towards the kills, and everything I come around and just take it from him. That must be so freaking frustrating to this guy. And I guess that's what this weapon is really good for. And now I got him too. Oh man, this is just too funny. I had tears in my eyes. Oh boy. Alright, so you think you're safe over there? Well, with this shield, you are safe. Yeah. It will take me like a million hours to get through this shield. But I guess I don't have anything to lose. Because he's not gonna get in range to me. You always hit that shield no matter what. So he's coming. He's closing in on the distance there. It's the same guy whom I stole all those kills from. Alright, here we go. Keep walking. Yeah, break that physical shield of this guy. That's awesome. Ah, my kill. Bah. Oh god, the same guy. I just keep stealing kills from the same person. It's so cool. I mean, to be honest, in this case, I worked down the HP myself. But still, he wanted to be the one getting this one. And I was like, nope. The problem is, I don't really stand a chance now. This is pretty much impossible for me to win this. He's still holding up his shield. You can see it there. He's still holding up the shield. While aiming at me, he's still holding it up. What I have to do? There's no chance. We can't do anything to each other anymore. From the scene, just the race, like, and it's a race that I've created in my head, you know? But you have to step away. Gotcha. See, it's... This is not such a no-skill weapon. You have to aim. I can dash and I can try to shoot him, but it will not work. Ah, you lost targeting, huh? Didn't you? Ah, gotcha. He keeps losing his track. See, this is what I mean about the noob weapon. He dashes, he hits the button, the weapon self-aims and hits you. And when you try to do this with weapons like Taran's or the ballista in this case, you have to manually counter your movement with your cursor and aim specifically at a certain spot where you don't even know exactly where it is. And that's what makes this weapon also too powerful, I think. The shock train. That it has this never-missing ability somehow. That's just so crazy. But it's, you know, slowly we're getting to things that you can counter it. You see, the Dragoon is a really good counter to Shock Train when you have it on the right bots. Money, what did Klaus say from World of Tanks? Klaus Kellermann. Klaus is, he's a World of Tanks YouTuber. And I know him because I watch his content. And hold on, I'm gonna focus him. I want this guy. Damn it. I was trying to get this kill. Okay, I got it. But I wanted to focus the Haichi so I get this kill. Oh no. Oh, he's coming so fast. Oh god, is this thing fast. The Kamiho is so ridiculously fast. And there's another one, yes. How wonderful. So now I can decide whom I want to die to. What if these guys would attack each other? I got one out of this really, really bad situation. I actually managed to get out of this victorious. Oh, I get the second guy too. What the heck? Because of the fact that the Raven can jump so many times now. You have a bot now that has the ability to jump so often. See, he's at 300 meters range. He's got 300 meters and I have more range than that. I can't believe I'm still alive, by the way. I'm trying to regenerate my both jumps. Oh, I don't. I'm not gonna. Nah, I'm not gonna be. Oh, that was so close. It was so close. He is so close to death. Oh, I'm getting both of them. Wonderful. And now we have a shock train specter there around this corner. Oh, you know what? This guy just made me waste my jump. Yeah, you're gonna get that. This guy is now going to appreciate the heck out of the fact that I just had to use my jump. I had to use it. There was nothing I could have done to avoid it because the other guy just came around. The Griffin came and, oh, really? Aww. Now I have only one weapon left. I cannot miss any shots here. I have to hit with every projectile of this Tyrant. There we go. Uh-oh. Ooh, boy. Okay. Still trying to do something here. Nice. I get the kill. How awesome is that? If I was this other guy, you know, that's something you need to do. If you're playing Free For All, by the way, okay? Then you have the ability to choose your targets. You should always go for... If you are going to die anyways, because you have low HP, then you really, really need to try to find a target that that isn't yet winning. You know? You need to find a target that is right now losing. Because if you choose the guy who's winning anyways, then he will get the kill for you. And that's it. Okay, I think I didn't make that clear enough. Oh, really, you have to spawn right there. Wonderful. You know you're going to die anyways because you have very little HP, very low health. Then, yeah, definitely go and get yourself killed against the guy that is not winning. Because this way you can still have a chance to catch up to the first guy. What is this guy shooting at? I think he was just emptying his clip right there. Yep, nice. Got the kill. I'm probably gonna take some good damage now from behind. Hi, HE, in your shield. No, I was unable to get the last 2 HP into him. Oh, that was super unlucky. Everything worked perfectly fine. I walked into his shield, but then I was unable to make use of it because, or I couldn't use it entirely anymore because I was too low on HP. If I had 5 HP more or 10, I would have probably been able to do some really good stuff with this. Let's make him use his jump. There it is. And even if I could jump after him now to get in firing range, I'm not going to. I only use my jump if I if it promises me to stay alive longer. That's what I use the jump for. Alright, so there goes the Inquisitor. Hold on. This guy is at low health. Okay, we might be able to get him here. Okay, I'm trying to regenerate my ember. See, maybe he's now going to do what I just said. He knows he's at low HP. He knows I'm the first one on this map. I'm the winner, so to speak, right now. And if he just does the right thing at the right time, he might be... See, now he's getting killed by somebody. He doesn't care if this other guy gets the kill. It's about not giving me the kill because I'm the winner in this part, in this thing here. See, there it is. No chance to get the kill. All he had to do was dash around the corner, and then he gave the kill to somebody else who isn't a threat to him. Right now, I'm the big threat because I'm the most like high up on the rank here in this very match. And that's what you do if you play this game mode very well. You make these trades. You just sacrifice yourself against somebody who's... I can give him 5 kills. I don't care. Hmm. Yeah. He knows I have 350 meters range with this ember. He's dancing somehow. He's not even fighting back. Yeah. Can't do anything. Isha is his name. I think he's not, he doesn't actually want to fight. He was kind of trolling around a little there. Yeah, the good thing is you cannot corner shoot when you have against an Ember. You cannot corner shoot against Ember. The Ember is going to grill you when you try to do this. Is this Android? Phaser Slicer says. Yes, it is. Oh, it's this guy again. Oh my goodness, I just can't get rid of this guy. He just comes and comes and comes. Follows me everywhere. And I'm not getting the kill. See? They now know how it works. Just get yourself killed, that's fine, but don't get yourself killed by the guy who's winning the match anyways. And that's all you have to do to make sure that this way you cripple my performance. You completely cripple my performance in this match. All right, there we go. Whew! 12 kills. Hey, Manny, nice gameplay. Keep it up. Tractor Coxon. Thank you, man. Much appreciated. Well, let's see. No, we were too late. I'm down to so low HP. And there it is. All right. So I'm not going to use one of these points. I'm going to use the bot I have right here. Not sure what this is. Oh, it's an Inquisitor. And now he's going to jump. See? I knew he was going to jump now because he has no other choice but to jump. That's what you do with them if you force them. Wow. Look how much health I just lost in 2 seconds from his Ember. Wow, that's crazy. Is this guy the first? No, what was that over his name? There was some crown over him. What the heck? Hey, Manny, my man. Ashmundr Arud. Oh, man, I'm probably saying this so badly. I'm sorry. Hey, dude. Welcome aboard. Oh, really? You have another one of these? Can't fight back. Now I can fight back. But it's too late because now I'm getting hit from behind. Perfect timing for this guy to come in and destroy us both. He waited so long for this, and then the perfect time came for him to get an easy double kill, kind of. Well, right now he doesn't have the double kill yet, but I think he was going to get it in very short amount of time. Oh, are you kidding me? Oh! Oh, I did get it somehow. What? How? When? Okay, whatever. I thought I should have hit him with like 2 rockets, but it didn't happen and suddenly he get killed. Cool. Manny, do you play another game? Yes, I do play other games on Twitch. And when you scroll down in the description of the stream, you will find my Twitch channel and there we stream other games too. By the way, tomorrow, I'm not sure if I want to try to make it happen, but tomorrow would be another co-op gameplay session. The thing is, I plan to do this with Stupendous, another YouTuber friend that we have here on War Robots. Stupendous, great channel, go ahead, check it out, guys. He's also doing live commentary, for example. I was going to do a co-op session with him. The problem was... I think he has become a father again, and so he obviously has no time right now to make a live stream or so, and I understand that. So we can't do the co-op live stream as I planned it, and now I'm not entirely sure if we can still make it happen. What the heck? He's behind. Oh, wow! I thought I was gonna be able to get them, but wow, they're dashing left and right, these Haichis. Oh, I almost got the kill with the Ember here. Oh, that was so cool. Almost. Damn it. If I had gotten the kill through this tiny little gap, that would have been so funny. Yeah, see what he does now? He's probably gonna get himself killed by the other person there. Nope, I got it. Okay, wonderful. Oh, I'm getting killed now. Oh, that's bad. Now I can hit him pretty good with the ember. Yeah, that's pretty good right now. Look, he can't hit me anymore. His Taurons were reloading, and the angle of which, with the weapon on top mounted, I was able to hit him really well. Uh-oh, somebody wanted to steal the kill. Oh boy. I had absolutely no idea. Oh, hey. Ah, my kill totally deserved. Yoink, that's mine. Alright, so there's a Spectre came jumping at me. I'm not sure which one of these... it's this guy. This must be the Spectre that just came jumping at me here. And he is reloading his stealth jump right now. Regenerating more like it. Okay. I need to play skillful to get him to counter him. So what I'm doing now, I'm firing empty my weapons. I'm trying to bait his jump. I'm not sure if it's gonna work though. Because he's also just corner shooting. He's not really attacking me. From behind we have a Kamiho coming. I see the Kamiho coming right there. So that's a pretty hopeless situation I'm in right now. No matter what I do, I will get attacked. So now he's jumping. He wants to get me once my stealth ability drops. And he's somehow getting me really good. Oh, what? He dropped the door. Wow, dude. That was sick. Ugh. My stealth ability will be ready before his. And he's down. Oh, come off of it, dude. I just got out of this with absolutely nothing. This match, this round here, or this battle, I came out of it with nothing gained. I used my full Haichi here and my full Spectre, and I came out of this situation with zero gain. I only lost. And he had his double dash ready. You know what? I'm playing against very skilled people right now. He saved his both dashes so that once he gets in range, he can instantly start the double dashing and close 100 meters instantly. That's what he did. Closed 100 meters in 2 seconds. See, when you are right above him, you can't hit him. That's crazy. We had a donation popping in from Sugar Hero with $1. Thank you, man. Or 1 euro. Sorry, it was 1 euro. Oh, wait a minute. There's something else, too. Am I in danger right now? Yes, I am. I am in danger. Hold on a second. I need to check. Oh, come on. Yes, I got him. Woo! That was super close. I'm going to read what came in. Uh-oh. See that Haichi is targeting me the whole time? Look how they all want- Why is it- All three are coming purely for me. That's crazy. That's a heck of a really crazy thing. So I think I should be the one getting this kill now. Yep. Okay. And this kill too. Haha! That's what you get for shooting into my shield for so long, dude. Yep. Okay. There's another Haichi or something like this coming. The Lancelot I could kill super quick. Look, the Lancelot is not attacking the Haichi. Now this height, she lost his shielding. And now he's very careful. Yeah, and now he's just gonna let me run into this shield, into this thing. He's gonna win. He's got too much firepower still left. My jump messed it up. My own jump. I should have not jumped over cover. I should have jumped, landed on cover, not over cover. That was my problem. But I have time now to read. Sugar Hero, kann ich mitspielen? Can I play with you? No, this is not a co-op session today. We're gonna do this another time. And tomorrow, probably. Butterslop Plays said, remember me from last time? Also, I got an ember from my super chest yesterday. Wow, congrats, dude. Oh, come on. Yeah, yeah. Did you see that monstrous jump that we've just done? Oh my goodness, that was so crazy. I didn't think we were gonna be able to get this, but we did. I want to reload my my Scourge. And I need both of my jumps. I need both of my jumps to deal with this guy. Nah, look at him. He's like, oh, I know where you're going. And he's waiting for his rockets to send them along. And of course, the second he wants to... Oh, now I'm going to start shooting. Boop, I reverse course in midair. And he's like, what? Too good. Congrats, man, on the ember. That's a really good thing. Yeah. There was nothing I could have done about this. You know what? I don't want to give them cheap kills, so I'm going to drop in with my own Spectre now, too. Because I could ride with the Fury now, but with these against the stealth jump Spectre with four Orkans, the answer sheet is not going to help you survive this. Meanwhile, he has easily regenerated his stealth jump again. To be honest, I expected him to jump. But we're so careful, all of us. So this Bulgazari right there, he is like, he will take so much damage from this guy. What I'm trying to do now, I'm trying to lure these guys together. I'm trying to walk around this thing so that this Bulgazari now goes for this guy. Because he has the Orkans, he can kill the Bulgazari easily. I can't do anything against the Bulgazari, really. See, now these two guys are super close together, and they're probably battling it out this time. So here comes the Spectre. Oh, there would have been a chance for me to sneak that kill away from him. No, not getting stuck now. So he's waiting for his stealth jump to come back, and hopefully he's not getting it. Oh, wow. That was really... That was Shock Train. That was just... That was not... It was not OP. It was not lame. It was Shock Train. If you want to get an exaggeration to lame and overpowered, then you will use Shock Train, okay? From now on, if you want to make sure the enemy knows what you mean, or the other guy knows what you mean, how insanely overpowered or badass or something is... then don't use overpowered or lame, because that's not strong enough. We're gonna use the word shock train instead in the future. Oh man, come on, that was so shock train. The train, I missed the train by 5 minutes. That was so shock train, dude. Oh, we have one coming in here. What is it? Butter slappers again with, or butter slap plays. Can we play iOS after the stream? If not during, my ID and, loving the stream. I'm not even having... I don't have iOS, dude. I can't play on iOS. That's my problem, right? I do not have the ability to play iOS with you. If you want to do co-op streaming with somebody, Adrian would be your guy. You need to try to hit up Adrian, because I know he's playing on iOS and he has a chance to play with you. I already invited Adrian to my co-op live streams, right? But the problem is, he's on iOS and I'm on Android, so there's no way we can play together. I wish they would somehow make that possible. That would be really good. Let's see what this is. Okay. I'm getting it. Boom! Nice. But now I'm getting gotten. So, who's there? Okay. That was a Shock Train Haichi. Let's go and attack that Shock Train Haichi. Oh, frickin' lamer weapon. Ugh. You can't react that fast. It's impossible. It's just, boom, 1 second. And then there's an input delay if you turn your bot sideways. Alright, I know that we have broken through his physical shield right now. I've seen it, so I know I can take him out like that now. Good. I've seen that we've broken through this thing. And I know that there's an Haichi following me right now. Oh no. Oh, this is like the worst bad luck in the world. Why are you spawning here now? Why do you have to spawn right here? Like, seriously, dude? Come on, that's so cheap. That's so freaking cheap. So I hope this guy's attack- No, look, wow. They're not- look. Look, they're not even attacking each other. Oh, wow, dude. That's insane. See, that's what you get for your cheap crap. Alright, so I got this kill. Now hoping that I get him too. Yup. Nice. Ah! Okay. Didn't see that coming. Alright. Taran on the Inquisitor right there. So he's got 350 meters range. I need to be wary of that. I only have 300 meters. He gonna get completely killed now? Completely? Wow. Oh. Wait, is there rockets coming from the other side? Looked like there was. He's gonna dash. Got him. Nice. Okay. I took some unnecessary damage there on the corner. You know what? I'm now going to sit on this freaking spawn. Because it's so annoying that these guys spawn right next to me all the time. Wait a minute. Who's that? Somebody comes hovering over here. He's got RDB, yeah. What? What the heck? Dude, the game just targeted somebody else! I was firing rockets at him, and I had him killed, and then somehow the target switched from up there to the Lancelot on the ground in 600 meters distance, out of my weapon range. Oh my god, the targeting system is such crap in this game. Seriously. How can it be so flawed? Why would the auto-targeting suggest a target I can't even freaking hit? That doesn't even make sense. I just lost the kill because of that. Oh, you probably want to target this guy, huh? He's way out of your range. Yeah, you probably want to get him. Yeah, you do. Ugh. This is so annoying. I had him, man. So good. It was an easy thing. And then, right in the moment when I need the firepower, right then. Oh, switch. And the other guy gets the kill. Ugh. raging money, yeah. It's when things are so dumb, like when things are so easy avoidable, just program the targeting system that it doesn't switch by itself to a target that's outside of your weapons range. Especially when you are literally in combat with someone right in front of me. Like, what sense does it make to switch over the target at such a moment? And then in particular to one you can't even fire at. I mean, you don't have have to be a genius in order to make this targeting system, you know, a little bit smarter than that. Yeah. I knew it was gonna happen. I knew he was gonna get killed by somebody else. Like, I'm okay with, you know, getting killed because a Spectre just jump-stealthed me or something. But what I really disagree with is when things are avoidable, right? When problems or bugs are avoidable, and yet they're not avoided. Like, that's when what I hate. Problems are easily avoidable and then yet there are not. Oh no, now my Ember is... Oh. I still got it somehow, okay. I thought I'm not gonna get it because the Ember was out of commission. He was reloading. And I think that the target, you know, I think that's a really quick change, right? The targeting system? I think that goes so quick. Just overhauling the targeting system slightly? That's probably such a quick change. Just so it doesn't suggest target by itself that are outside of the range. That's pretty much already what you need. See, I used my Orkin rockets. And he used one of his dashes. There's another dash and now he's toast. Because now he used both of his dashes and doesn't have a chance. Now there is somebody coming with Scourge. Also a Haichi. Oh my god, where are this guy coming from now? Okay, what am I doing now? I don't know. Jump stealth is not ready. The only thing I can do is die. If I had been able to activate my stealth jump one more time, then I could have done something. Damn it. Where did this guy even come from with his Inquisitor? I don't know. So this Inquisitor has just used his jump. Might as well do this. Nice. Before he's able to do another jump, I'm just gonna take him out. I could have also killed him here, but I don't have to. Because the Inquisitor would have been the bigger and more frightening target. Yeah, I don't know. Why aren't you at least looking at me, dude? You were trying to shoot me before. Suddenly he turned around and I don't know what he did. He thought like, okay. He's out of range. I'm just gonna walk this way now. My kill. Meh. There he comes. Woo! So, now what do you do? Are you gonna let me regenerate my Orkin rockets all the way and also my, my stealth jump, really? Because that's not very smart. You should actually push me. You need to push me now because, yeah, now it probably is already too late. Oh, you know what? I have an idea. What? I just lost my Orkin rocket. That probably cost me the victory here. The fact that I just lost my Orkin rocket. That one was very important because only with this Orkin I could have absorbed the damage. No chance. It was the Orkin rocket that I lost. So incredibly unlucky, dude. He would have never scored the win. He never would have won if I hadn't lost this Orkin rocket. And with the loss of this rocket, the DPS was not enough anymore to drop his shield and get the kill. It was literally this one rocket launcher that was missing in DPS to get him easily and quickly killed. Oh boy. He's not even walking anymore because I don't think he wants to. He is, okay. There he is. What is he coming with? We're battling it out. I would have walked and dodged a few of his rockets. Can't compare a short medium brawler weapon to a long heavy weapon. Yeah. The short range brawler is always going to outperform the long range brawler when you are very close. Although the Scourge is a very good exception in this rule. Because what it does, it has this massive damage amplifier when you get close to your enemy. Show us the new stuff. Raven, Ballista, and... I've already used it before. I'm gonna go with this hanger this time. I've already shown it before, guys, the other thing, what is it? The flux. See how this bot just outperforms you by tenfold because of this freaking dash and the freaking shield. Ah! The Rhino is such an outdated bot, it can't compete anymore with this. Whoa, we have a donation coming in. No chance. What was that? Butter slap plays again with $1. You said if you wanted to call play, go to Adrian, but you're not much more... but you're much more entertaining. Well, I disagree. I think Adrian is a really funny guy. I have watched a lot of his streams, and I always enjoy his streams a lot. I find them super cool. Nice. Got him before he went around the corner. Not sure if I will be able to get his kill too. Nope. I won't, unfortunately. But I think if Adrian is a really funny guy, and it's always cool to watch him, so... I disagree that he would be less entertaining or whatever. Uh-oh, what is coming here? Okay, we have a full Lancelot coming. He is almost in range to shoot me. But thankfully, I can walk backwards and he had already used... Oh man, see what just happened? I walked back against the wall and I was kind of stuck there. There we go. Got him. Oh, frickin'. Are you kidding me? Look at the amount of damage he just did to me. I just lost like 50 or 60% of a Natasha from this one hit. That's what you get for it. What is this? Okay, it's an it's a Taran. I don't think I have a chance against him there. Damn it, I could have maybe kill-steal there. Kill-stealing has always priority. I can't win. No way, man. No way. Oh, almost! Almost! I could have almost kill-stealed that one. Ah, no. That was unfortunate. He's got 300 meters range, and I can shoot over this corner, and... Nice! Snaggled mine. That's right. Oh, there would be a one-hit kill right there. Damn it. Oh, he's like 2 meters out of range. Oh, man. The music has stopped, hasn't it? But you know what? It's not a problem because this is the last round anyways for tonight, guys. We have had a wonderful live stream with some emotional moments with me getting upset about freaking Shock Train crap, which I think everyone should get upset about this because it's just so terrible. And we had so much damage in so many cool, crazy rounds. He's always changing direction of this thing and I just keep focusing him. But I have no chance. Damn it. So, we have this thing now. Yep, my kill. Nice. Cool. So, oh, we have two jumping stealthers. Two stealth jumpers. There goes the Inquisitor taking some good hits. Problem is, I can't kill him. And he's going to jump now. I knew it. I knew he would. Especially since I just used my double jump. No, he's like, oh god, you gotta be kidding me, man. He had nothing left. He had nothing left. Oh boy. No! Oh my god, this guy's just getting all the kills right now. Oh, now he wants to get me too. You know what? I'm not going to let him kill me. Yes, I kill him. Wonderful. And then I let this guy kill me so I can maybe turn it around. Let's see. The problem is I don't have really the good setups that work so well that let me kill enemies super easily here. That's why this time we were so close. Because I'm really, really, really far away. Yeah. Yes. Because I don't have the good setups this time. That's my problem. Look how much damage he does. Oh man! He does such ridiculous amounts of damage. Now he just regenerates the shield, easy peasy going. I want to get it, but I don't think I will. Nope. Nope. Dang it. Absolutely chanceless, dude. No chance at all. I think the only thing I can try to do is hop into this bad boy again and maybe get some kills. But it's this hangar that I'm running right now is a fun hangar with a little bit of crazy stuff. It's not really meant to brawl with high-end free-for-all setups. The other hangar, I think I've not lost a single match with him, but this one here is not really free-for-all. Somebody else got the kill. Oh man. Nothing I can do. Hmm. Too weak. It's weird when the music stopped, isn't it? It's so weird. I think this might be in Haichi right there. Haichi with Orkans, I suppose. One more shot. A single more shot was all I needed. Only one more shot. And this is how I lose my games right now. This is how I lose the kills. One single shot and I would have gotten him. Hmm. Oh well. This match is over. I'm not gonna win this one here at the end. That's clear. Now I have a 3-second reload on this. Now he has the brawling weapon, the brawling setup. I don't. My weapon is not brawly. My weapon is, how you call it? It's a sniper, actually. This is a sniping weapon. See, this hangar is absolutely... Is there anything in this hangar that is really meant to play FFA? This Lancelot there is okay, but that's probably the only thing that I should be using. Yeah. No good round at the end here. Woo! I got him some hits there. Across the entire map. That's the weapon, right? The new one. What's it called? Ballista. Ballista Mark II, level 12. Regenerating much faster than things does. What's it called? The trebuchet. Thirty-3 seconds. Not sure if this is gonna be if I'm gonna be able to kill him here, within that time. Yo, I think I might be able to, but he will try to jump at me in a second again. Okay, there we go. Oh, there would be another kill right there. I'm not sure. Would be funny if I could sneak that one away. Don't think so though. Yes, I did. Boom. That put me on place 2 on this map. Oh, God. At least something that I was able to do at the end. All right. But, you know, that shows you guys that if you want to play Free For All, you need to change your hangar for it, right? I was 1 kill short of it only, but you need brawling bots. This right here is a brawling setup. This is a Free For All hangar. This right here is a sniping team deathmatch domination hangar where you have some good medium long range stuff and a good variety of different things that you can use, but you don't have the brawling power that you need with a shield and dash like the Haichi or the stealth jump like the Spectre that you need for the free fall. So it's very important if you really play this mode, if you go here and you want to play this like a lot and not play anything else, then make sure to adjust your hangar so you can have things that work very well in free fall that give you an edge in very close range combat, because you don't really have long range combat. The only way where it's good is in Canyon, in stealing kills with a trebuchet, for example. That works, but that's the only place where it works, right? So make sure to pick the right things, not unlike the stuff I showed you here at the end. And I want to say one more thing, guys, one more time, that all you guys who were here watching, we had so many people watching here this live stream, amazing. And all you guys chatting, all you guys making donations, thank you guys so much. I think Boulder Slap Plays, where's one? Kein Rückzug. Wait a minute. Kein Rückzug? Dito on Adrian, not a... Oh, wait a minute. Kein Rückzug has given us a donation and I haven't seen it. When is these things happening? What the heck? Oh my god. I'm so sorry, dude. Kein Rückzug. Money. Dito on Adrian, not a fan, but the 3.8 update from what is from what I see. Yeah, but I would give him a chance. Just go ahead, watch some of his streams. I'm pretty sure you're going to find some joy in it, because I certainly do. And I want to say thank you also once again, Kind of Look Soup, for your contribution, man. That was so cool of you. And sorry about me noticing this so late. Dude, that's crazy. Then Suithead 408 with $42 on Super Chat. That's awesome. Dominique M with a $10 donation. Splex Gem. And I'm Yellow Snow. And I think I missed maybe a few Super Chats in between. Sorry if I did, but, yeah, I want to come to an end because it's getting really late and you guys don't want to sit through the end of this, just me talking about something like this. So, let me just say thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, leave a like and comment down below, and if you haven't already, hit subscribe, as brutal as a man can it for more. Thanks for bearing with me. You guys are awesome, as always. Money Gaming signing off from a room that's approximately 40 degrees Celsius. Bye-bye. I don't know why, guys, but it's getting so freaking hot in here. It's the PC, it's all these devices that run, the screens and the flashlight, this lamp up there that makes everything very bright, so that you see me very well with the green screen, and oh my god, it's making it so hot. I'm sweating so much. I'm not sure if you can see it, but it's the case. But yeah, see you guys around next time with the next videos, and tomorrow might be a stream for the co-op custom hangar. But I'm gonna have to check, because I planned it with Stupendous. Now this is not gonna work. We have to see how we do it, okay? So, goodbye. Good night.